in the lead. They're driving us back.
You fell into the hole you dug yourself.
Dropped one.
Watch the queen, throw a grenade, queen.
Got the guy that was in the gondola, got him.
Smoke yourself something nice.
Wow.
I'm in their spawn. Finish your move, baby.
Fuck yeah! Eat it, bitch!
I just came.
Oh,
I just
yeah!
To see that.
Did you seriously see that shit?
Fuck is shooting me. I can't tell where it's coming from.
Bad dog. Bad dog. I took out your crutch, Metal Man.
Hello.
Oh my God, I'm lucky I got that one.
Is it me you're looking for?
Double kill, baby. Let's fucking go, man.
Kill always revitalizes me.
Hostile recon spotted.
Doing good at first.
Oh, look at you. Play the game, bro.
See?
Oh, yeah.
The hell was that?
Oh,
that. I was looking at the Game Pass for it, and you have to have, like, it's $10.99 a month, or, well, basically $10 a month for the regular pass, and then I found out if they rotate the games, I'll lose that game. So I'm like, I might as well just buy it. You know, I might as well just buy it. How do you host? You can do, side slash, or forward slash host. And then the name with your phone.
Both 10. I have not hit double digits. I got on.
Haven't hit them double D's. Look at this. Watch this shit, dude. Like, it's not me camping. I'm like, they're just everywhere. Like, it just kind of walk in front of my bullet.
We're in the lead. They're driving us back.
You fell into the hole you dug yourself.
Dropped one.
Watch the queen, throw a grenade, queen.
Got the guy that was in the gondola, got him.
Smoke yourself something nice.
Wow.
I'm in their spawn. Finish your move, baby.
Fuck yeah! Eat it, bitch!
I just came.
Oh,
I just
yeah!
To see that.
Did you seriously see that shit?
Fuck is shooting me. I can't tell where it's coming from.
Go get him! Double kill!
Bad dog. Bad dog. I took out your crutch, Metal Man.
Oh my God, I'm lucky I got that one. Double kill, baby. Let's fucking go, man.
Kill always revitalizes me.
Hostile recon spotted.
Doing good at first.
Oh, look at you. Play the game, bro.
See?
Oh yeah.
The hell was that?
No point in wasting time.
I was looking at the Game Pass for it, and you have to have like, it's $10.99 a month, or well, basically $10 a month for the regular pass. And then I found out if they wrote. All right. Make sure is it picking up the fucking audio? Because I don't know if it is. I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know. I'm confused. I'm conflustered. But anyways, let me look at one thing before we start 100% doing this. You hear us? Awesome. That's what I want to know. Thank you so much. Yeah. And we all know that Dillo's mic is in his face where he likes him. All right, now.
It's like everything.
In his face, yes. So today is the first episode of the whole Tangents talk show type thing. And it, like I said, it's more of a just two old fat guys just talking about stupid shit they went out through the day. Or the week, or whatever.
I'm the old one.
We'll go with that. Yes, 100%. So, we are also repping the Wrong Show's merch today. I got my favorite one out of the whole thing is this one. This is my favorite one. So, and the second shirt I let Dillo here use for today. So I was like, hell yeah, man, go for it, you know. And I'm excited to do this. We've been talking about this for
a long time.
Have you not seen the gray hairs? This is like a long time in the works to do this. Like we've been talking about this for like what? Over a year almost. Yeah. Over a year, yeah. Over a year doing this. Like the sound alerts are on and everything. I know that they are. So I mean at one point, yes. I forgot about that. She did play one, didn't she?
Yeah. She played the hello.
Yeah. You have gray hair. I think Dillo's got you beat. I think he's got you beat on the gray hair. But like today is basically us just explaining what's going on, what's new with this thing. This will be right now for what we're doing. I think we're doing what? Twice a month? Every other weekend, right?
Maybe.
Around there somewhere. We're trying to go for Saturday, but Saturday just didn't work. So Saturday was a no go this week.
Had to go
do Christmas stuff. So that's the only reason why we didn't do it Saturday like we all planned. But I put it in Discord that, you know, things changed. We had to do it on Sunday. And I think you were the one that actually brought that up, was the whole Sunday thing. Because I didn't. I think
Sunday,
you did.
Sunday.
Exactly. And of course, he has his set to, you know, let's get ready to rumble on his mic there. He swore up and down. He's like, well, when I get this, I'm gonna have it, you know, say, let's get ready to rumble. So I was like, I'm waiting for it. I was waiting for it.
Yeah, he was.
Right. But basically, like, what we talked about, everybody's like, well, do you have a topic for the show? Like, really don't have topic because the show has no topics. Like, if you guys have topics for the show, like, you are more than welcome to put them in the chat.
Shut the fuck up.
Fuck Anonymous. Like, all right, I gotta see who that is. But Anonymous played it. But basically, if you guys have topics or anything you guys want us to talk about, we're more than welcome to, you know, discuss it and check it out. See what we can do with it. Another thing is, like, what was it the other day? We watch a lot of movies. And a lot of movies. Oh, it was her. She did it. I was like, who the fuck played that shit? Because that's 10 babies for that motherfucker. I'm like, who played that shit? And, but yeah, we watch a lot of movies and critique a lot of movies. And every time we do that, we're like, we should be talking
ironic,
about this.
Yeah.
Yes. So, all right, we're going to talk about Memory Lane real quick. Because me and Dillo were at Walmart. He's like, you know, we got to go to Walmart and look at some stuff. And he decides to go down like the not toy aisle, but where did we start at? We were leading to Memory Lane. We were just going through dumb shit and we're like, oh, look at that.
We were going through and stopping. Well, we started, I think what we were initially doing was the toy section. Nerf guns.
Yeah. Yeah. It was Nerf guns. We were looking at Nerf guns and we were talking about how a lot of them look like Fortnite. Why do they gotta screw shit up for people like our generation did not have?
It's like everything is Fortnite.
Yeah, everything's gotta be Fortnite this, Fortnite that. And I'm not trying to hate on Fortnite. I'm really not. Like, why do you have to put the toys in it? Like, leave it into the games. Leave it there. But well, the market wants it, so I get it. But
it's called merchandise.
Yeah, and the sad part is I went through marketing, so I'm like, I know exactly why they're doing it. Like, I know why they're doing it. But like, so we're going down memory lane. We're looking at stuff like, man, I grew up with that. Yeah, I grew up with this game. And
then we found this thing. First thing caught our eyes was before it was a tabletop game that was called Blockbuster Game.
Oh my god, yeah.
And the case for it is the shape of a Blockbuster video.
Identical to what we grew up with. You know, of course there were other ones before that, but Blockbuster was one of the big ones, you know, Family Video and Video Connection back in the 80s, early 90s, like all those shit, that was our shit back in the day. But yeah.
It was.
But I mean, everything's going digital, which is normal.
Of course, in our town, the local video rental shop is called Video Spectrum.
Spectrum, that's right, yeah. And with the Video Spectrum, there was it. No, it wasn't Video Connection. There was it. Wasn't there a Video Connection? No.
There was a Video Connection, but it turned into Movie Gallery.
That's it. Yep. Fuck them. But yeah.
Well, they're no longer.
Yeah. I mean, there's one Blockbuster left in the world right now.
In Oregon.
And it's owned because it's, isn't it like a family owned business because of the fact there's the last one?
It's still technically owned, but it's run by a family.
Right. And as you can see, there's a vintage Batman clock back there. That's mine. I was looking at it.
Yeah.
And it's got from Adam West Batman on top of that. Like one of the OG Batmans, like the one that I remember started off with was Adam West. Black and white, good stuff. And fucking, I was like, that's gotta be a frame because we did a podcast on Mortal Kombat that I found on my laptop, which posted on YouTube as well. Swayman, what's up? Thank you for the alert, bro. Thank you so much. I wish we had like a moderator in here that could do the shout outs for us. Because I'm like, hello? Damn it. Well, yeah, you came with your phone, actually, if you wanted to. You're like, hello. Like you said, hello. Is it me you're looking for?
Don't make me.
You can, Harley, if you want. Please. I should make Harley a mod, actually. I should do that. I didn't think about that.
I should
make Harley a mod. Harley wants to be a mod. Raise your hand if Harley wants to be a mod.
I'm busy typing. You have to ask that. Right.
Hello, who is it this time?
Harley again.
That's right, Harley. Yes. Harley, if you want to be a mod, let me know. Like, just put it in chat. Like,
she did just say
that. I guess it's true. I didn't even think it. I wasn't even looking. I'm like, wait a minute. But yeah, yeah, I'll do that. Give me a little bit. Like I said, this is mod me. Alright, hold on. You're making me do all the hard stuff. Give me a second. I don't know if I can do this with, because the mouse is on my lap. I can't see anything.
Yeah.
Stupid fucking. I'm so fat.
Okay. Right.
Yeah.
Shh.
Yeah. I'm doing it later. I'm not doing it right now. Wait, no, I can. I can do it right here. Can I? Can't see. I mean, alright, you're going to have to do this because I can't see. Wait. There is actually.
That's just showing her badges.
It should be a thing for her. God damn it. God damn it. Back button. Ah. Right. It pissed me off. Back button. I'm hitting it on my mouse. I don't even know what the hell that shit is. All right. Right.
Fat man.
Right. Fuck this. Pissing me off. Goodbye. Nope. Yep. We're good with that. Where is it? Right there. All right. Fuck this shit.
But if you wanted to try and do it, you'd have to go switch site.
Right. And do it that way. Yeah. No, I'll do it later. I promise. I will. I'm sitting there fucking making things so goddamn rough on my. Did you fart on that one?
No, I see.
Okay. But anyway,
it,
so.
It just popped my back. You know how.
My back. My God, dude. If you type exclamation or remember the / burp, remember that? / mod. Yeah, there we go. Good idea. Let me see if I can do it with my phone real quick. I might be able to pull that off of my phone, actually.
Wish I could.
I might be able to. I'm not guaranteeing
sure
that.
Moderators can't moderate.
That's a good question. Sickness is in the house. Let's fucking go, man. Holy shit. You already know. Yeah, I was like, I knew it was. Like, right off the get. Like, I knew it was. There's no doubt.
Well, the moment you heard it.
Yeah. Like, yeah. There he is. He's in the house. sickness. I don't know if you can do it either. It's a good question.
There you go.
Ah, edit stream info, stream manager. There we go. Okay.
Forgot to hit.
Oh, thank you for the shout out. Yep, Dillo did the shout out for me. I got to figure out. Yep, I can do it right here. Okay, so this. Dude, my eyeballs are so fucking bad right now. What did he say? It would be.
Okay, it would mod. /mod.
And then add their name. Ghost Moses has spoken. I'm like, no, that's not what I want. Oh my God. HR. A R L three. You look bald. U 1 NN.
Right, if I catch that right, just
9281. Right. Oh my God.
Solar flare.
Let's fuck off. There we go. Oh, it didn't work. Oh well. I think I put the name in wrong. I think that's why it didn't work. But anyways. We'll just keep going. I will definitely do the Harley because you said you were up for it, so I will do it.
Oh,
when we get.
How'd you spell it?
I spelled it the way it was, but. Sickness with the resub. Let's fucking go, man. Hell yeah. That's awesome, dude. I appreciate you, man. I appreciate you. You know that. We both have our phones just sitting here. He's better off with that because I just can't see shit. Like, I can't see nothing. I actually put my computer to 75%.
It's going
to
be the only way I can.
Right,
type
right.
Too,
right.
If I type it, like, it's going to come up.
Start doing that. But so we were 4 months in a row. Yeah, fuck yeah, dude. Hell yeah. So we were going down memory lane again. Like we were talking about the Blockbuster thing, and it's literally a game, but it looks like a video cassette. And he's like, dude, I wish I could. But it was $21 before taxes. Right. Imagine owning a $21 piece of plastic that you're not ever going to touch ever again. You're just going to have, like, look, this is badass.
Because it looks,
you know?
To me, it looks better as a display piece than
facts,
actually playing, because nowadays, who's really going to know?
Right. That's something that we grew up with, like, back in the day. Like, oh, dude, let's go to Blockbuster, you know? What was it? 4 kids movies for free, and then after that, or kids movies were free, I think.
Yeah, something.
But
gross.
Yeah. Anyways, but yeah, like
no.
That's
you gotta go.
I can't do it as good as you, and you know that. Dill, your mic is a little quiet. Oh, he's like, let me adjust. Let me tweak it just a tad bit.
Let me gain it up.
Let me gain it up. I
get
have
some
I,
gains, bro.
Yeah, that's right. We need to get gains, bro. Like, yeah. But we're going because I also have mine. We both
now
have.
How do I sound?
Yeah. Let us know. Like, if there's any audio issues, please let us know right off the get. We need to know. I know mine's loud because I like to have mine like right here normally. Like, you know, up in the grill. You know, I like to have it right here. You guys see me when I'm gaming. You know where mine always is. There we go. Sounds good. Thank you
knew,
so much.
I knew I had to get some gains.
Had to get some gains. Yeah. But like he said, like nobody these days knows about that kind of shit because everything's digital now. And like we said, there's only one fucking Blockbuster left. You're echoing in the tab.
You don't forget. Don't forget they had Netflix the board game too.
Oh my. Yes. They had Netflix the board game. And what was the other one that we saw? Well, we did get one thing. We did get one thing while we were there. We got the horror trivia, which is holding our mic right now up in the air. And I was like,
otherwise you'd have crotch shots.
You'd have crotch shots. You don't want crotch shots in here. I mean, no, we don't want that.
Yeah, we don't want to
wear our crotches.
We don't want to let them. We don't want to let them know that we're not wearing pants.
Right. Yeah.
Shit.
It's all business up top, party in the bottom, bro. You know. But yeah, it's a horror trivia game. Like me and him went through it. We're like, all right, we got to check this out because there was a question on there that we could not figure out.
9 days and 13 hours.
Fuck yeah. He subbed the first, like, I think it was the first or second day I was streaming that he caught my stream. I think he subbed that day. Like, I don't know why that was not working.
We'll find out here in a sec.
No, it doesn't work. I don't know why the subbage one doesn't work. I have no idea. It doesn't say.
Huh.
Let's see. 7 months, 27 days, 21 hours. And if you guys want to know.
Well, that's Harley.
Yeah, that's Harley's. If you guys want to know how I'm able to see this.
The subage thing, I don't think works because I don't think you
got to. They took that off, actually. Now think about it. They took that off. Like when they did one of when they changed shit, that used to be one of the ones that I had on there at one point. And it doesn't work now. And I'm like, why isn't it working? I don't understand. It's just not working.
Well, maybe it was a Streamlabs alert. You're not using Streamlabs.
I just adapted everything to it. Yeah. I don't know. I'll go through it, figure it out. Followage, 3 months, 18 days. Nice.
Maybe you need to add that in your commands.
I probably will. I'm going to do it myself.
Sickness is a mod.
Yeah, he can go through stuff and change stuff. Gains, baby. Toyman is the one with the gains. Young, athletic, strong. Oh, yeah. We're like the wrong show if they let themselves go. Like we were talking about. I'm Elvin if he let himself go. And you would be Danny if he let himself go too.
Yeah.
And
this is the result. They both
actually wear glasses.
This is the result of
sickness with 1,000 biddies. Holy shit. Yeah, y'all. Are crazy, all right? Y'all are crazy. Oh my god.
I
love that one. I love the Kamehameha one, dude. I do.
Yeah.
I mean, if it's too loud, you can use the mouth.
I'm just saying, I think that we just look like them when the beer finally catches up.
Oh, I know, right? I forget about the gym, all that stuff. Like, yeah. But so we were going through. We gotta get back. We were going through memory lane. And we found this horror trivia game. You know, he got it and everything. He put it in the cart.
Oh, he's like, man, I really want this. I'm like, you really want this? And he's like, yes.
Yeah,
and I threw it in. I do. Cart.
We're echoing bad. Is there seriously an echo? Hold on 1 second. Let me do something.
Oh. Something. Oh, she's probably hearing us over there. Probably. You know what it is? We're picking each other up on the mic.
Probably, yeah. Sensitivity's up high. It could be.
Yeah.
We'll adjust it later. I mean, I know that it's probably what it is because the mics are really close. Well, this is like our first time doing this, so what I'll probably do for mine is I'm going to figure out a way to put mine over here because I have 25-foot cords for both of them.
Well, that was the initial idea is we were going to put them on the ends and then...
Right. That's actually what we're going to do next time is, like, the cords are long as hell, so I'm going to have mine sitting over here beside me and coming across this way, and his will be over here. I'm going to catch you, Dillo. Going to take me. He's going to try to catch up with you and Biddies. Is what he's talking about. He's like, I'm slowly getting there. But you got to remind you, dude. Okay. Every time Sickness comes in, he does play blurps constantly. So that's 2 Biddies per time, right?
But yeah, you'll have to catch up hard if I end up dropping another 10,000 bits on his birthday.
Oh, he says you're not echoing. It's because they're in the bedroom. They think they're echoing. It almost sounds like it's because it's the sound bouncing off the walls in the bedroom.
Yeah.
I was like, I don't hear anything. That's why he's laughing.
Yeah.
But anyways, so back to what we're talking about. And this happens all the time. Yeah. Go off subject. This is why it's called tangents, guys. Literally, because we go off subject all the time.
Yeah, but, wait until we start talking about movies.
You go on movies and it's going to be like, but remember this one was kind of like that. Wait, what were we talking about?
Again? A line in a movie sends
us into a whole other conversation. Completely different. Tyson was going.
He has to go to the
bar. Are you kidding me, man? Seriously, I'm going to whoop ass. Like, seriously.
Yeah. Sounds like a potty break.
Doesn't it? Give me 1 second. Fucking. Back in that wasn't supposed to be here. All right, guys, give me 1 second. I have to let my dog out. 1,500 till I get. Wow, that's pretty fucking close.
What?
1,500 till he gets 1,500 till he gets his purple scythe at Biddy's.
Sweet.
So Not bad.
Wait until you get your rainbow scythe.
Yeah, he's like, yeah, wait for that one. All right, guys. I hate to say it, but give us a second. I have to let my dog out. Give me 1 second, and we will be right back. I did not expect this because this was supposed to be fixed before this happened. So, yeah, I can't see. All right. But, yeah, I'll be right back. Guys, give us a second, and we'll see you in, like, 5 minutes.
We're in the lead. They're driving us back.
You fell into the hole you dug yourself. It's not you. Dropped
one.
Got the guy that was in the gondola. Got him.
Wow.
I'm in their spawn. Finish your move, baby.
Fuck yeah. Eat it, bitch.
I just came.
Oh,
I just
yeah.
By to see that.
Did you seriously see that shit?
Fuck is shooting me. I can't tell where it's coming from.
Bad dog. Bad dog. I took out your crutch, Metal Man.
Oh my god, I'm lucky I got that one. Double kill, baby. Let's fucking go, man.
Kill always revitalizes me.
Hostile recon spotted.
Doing good at first.
Oh, look at you. Play the game, bro.
See?
Oh, yeah.
The hell was that?
Oh, that. I was looking at the Game Pass for it, and you have to have, like, it's $10.99 a month, or, well, basically $10 a month for the regular pass, and then I found out if they rotate the games, I'll lose that game. So I'm like, I might as well just buy it. You know, I might as well just buy it. How do you host? You can do, // host. And then the name with your phone.
Both, and I have not hit double digits. I got on.
Haven't hit them double D's. Look at this. Watch this shit, dude. Like, I saw me camping. I'm like, they're just everywhere. Like.
Sorry, guys. Doc had to go to the bathroom. My bad. My mic's on, right? Okay. Now, anyways, as we were saying.
Just like my
God, I'm so fat. I just like it's bam. Like,
it's like it's like a sudden shock of.
Yeah, let me try this.
Hey, like they always say, cameras add a few extra.
Well, yeah, but when I've got 10 cameras on screen. Me, that's what they say. How many cameras are on you? How many cameras are on you? But yeah, so we found this horror trivia game. Whatever, and there was one question out of all of them that we couldn't figure out.
We couldn't figure out because we're reading a box and we're like, it's really bothering us what it was, and then when we finally read it, we both felt stupid.
Oh, we felt dumb as hell because we were talking about the movie prior to it anyway. Like not even a couple weeks ago,
mentioned it. We were talking about the movie period in general.
Right. And it was Halloween. And it's talking about Haddonfield, and I'm like, why does that sound so familiar? But we can't figure out what it's from. We can't figure it out. And then all of a sudden we look and we're like, because we went through almost every single card, like naming stuff off. I was 70% on all of them almost. Probably the same for both of us.
You know how he's also a semi-Godzilla fan.
Yes. Rip with that shit.
Yeah, it had a Godzilla question and he got it wrong.
I was so mad. I'm like, seriously.
I got it right.
He got it right. Like, yeah, I was right. And then he's like, and then he reads it to me. I'm like, why does that sound familiar? And I got it wrong. I did. I was pissed at myself. I should have got that right.
I got it wrong. But here's the worst part. The card got it wrong too, because the right answer is not Gojira.
No.
It's Godzilla, King of the Monsters.
Yeah. Yep.
The 1956.
Yeah. The original. The original of originals. Literally. And, but, so we're, like, it was, we were going through, like, every card and reading them off. It's a fun game, too. Like, the way it's set up, it's a fun game. Like, I played it already with the kids and played it with the kids' old lady. And I mean, of course, I was like, I'll go ahead and I'll have to draw all five weapon cards to just give you guys a chance to win. Because you only have to get three different weapons and you're good and you win.
Yeah, but and, it's like you gotta at least answer six questions in order to
There's win. Two on each card.
Yeah.
And but yeah, like it was crazy because we went down and there was also what was that other game that we used to play all the time? There was Skip-Bo down there. There was fucking like old school looking Uno stuff.
Skip-Bo, Uno, Monopoly.
Oh my God.
Chutes and Ladders.
Oh yeah. Mousetrap.
Yes.
Oh my God, dude.
No, I never played that as a kid.
See, I did. I played Mousetrap when I was younger because my dad got it for me for Christmas one year. Didn't know what the fuck I was doing because I was little. I didn't understand it.
Don't forget the game of Sorry.
Oh my God.
Sorry.
And I'm not sorry. The game. we were playing. We went on
Parcheesi, Chess, Checkers.
Oh my God. Yeah, of course. All those originals. And but yeah, like going down memory lane was awesome. Like just we were looking at, and we sat in that aisle for about an hour. I would say just doing that. Just go like, oh my God,
they have this.
Oh my God, they have that. Too bad y'all don't live a little closer. We could we play Cards Against Humanity together. Like we're open to the guest star thing. I definitely have to
get this. That's another thing we saw there too.
Cards Against Humanity, yeah. $29.
Yes.
And I said that once I get the money. Just keep talking as it goes
nice
on.
Nice host, bro.
Exactly. Yes, yes. Awesome host. Don't raid, please. Because I'm sitting right here with a fan blowing on me, man. Don't be raiding in here. So, all right, that way everybody understands. So, there's an inside joke between the two of us, all right? I have a video clip that was an accidental video clip of me burping while mid-talk.
But it was perfect, though.
The mid-sentence talk, and it was hilarious. So, I turned my head away from the mic thinking that was going to help me from picking up the burp sound. It didn't do it, Jack. It made it worse.
It enhanced the burp.
It's back when I used my Blue Yeti blackout mic, that big black dildo-looking thing. Is my
which
mic
is sitting over there?
Yeah, it's over in the trophy.
That you were gonna put in the camera.
Yep. There you go. There's something on my lip. Okay.
He had his girlfriend before work.
Yeah, with leftovers. But
she's like, wait, what?
Wait, what? But yeah, that'd be awesome because we saw Cards Against Humanity there. I want to get it. It's $29. There's also a set on Amazon that I want to get because I'm a big Supernatural fan. I want to get Supernatural one. I want to get gifted a sub to Dr. X42. Thank you for the gifted sub, bro. Much appreciated. What is that? Did it say Hype Train again? I couldn't read it. I can't read that.
No, it wasn't a Hype
Train. Okay, I was like, it's beginning a Hype Train already.
No, it was just him gifting.
I was
the
like,
first,
shit.
Now the first sub for the month, I guess.
All right, nice. But thank you for the gifted sub, bro. Much appreciated. Thank you. I gotta fix this because it's pissing me. There we go. That's better.
He gifted a sub to Dr. X42.
Yep, I lost a sub. Or no, lost a follower today. I was like, okay, man, like it is what it is, you know. And I haven't been streaming for a while. Like this is my first stream in over a week.
You can't. You win some, you lose some.
Right. I mean, that happens.
Maybe some of the content you watch got bored with it.
Right.
Or maybe what you're playing now is not their cup of tea.
Exactly. Yeah. It happens.
They don't
like,
care.
A lot of the ones that followed me are the ones when I was playing Jackbox Party Packs. Remember, right. I started doing that all the time because I was like, I want to be more interactive with my followers and stuff like that. And it's just, that's what I do.
And then Call of Duty, new Call of Duty comes out.
Yeah. And I'm sorry for everybody that watches my stream and stuff. And I'm constantly playing Call of Duty, streaming Call of Duty all the time. Like, man, I always forget that the weekends are supposed to be Jackbox Party Pack weekends and stuff. And I feel bad about that because I haven't been sticking true to that. But I do want to start doing that again. Oh, shit. This is what. Always, man. Oh shit, guess they wasn't exactly, they wasn't the real ones. Exactly. I feel you there, dude. It's true. Like, I follow everybody that I followed is still there. Like, I don't just unfollow people. I'm back. My fiance called me. Oh, no problem, Harley. No problem. No problem. Stuff happens, you know. We get it.
You mean he didn't call you wife yet?
Oh god. Really?
Well, what else is he gonna call her?
Ah, Harley.
The love of his life.
There you go. That's better. That's much better. Kiss ass.
Most important person in his life?
There you go. VIP. Yes. True.
Very important person.
Yes. But yeah, so we got this horror game and stuff, and I like it a lot. Even when him and I were just reading the cards, it was a blast. Like, I had a blast with it.
Even though I felt like the show host doing
you're
it.
Like, yep, yeah.
If it wasn't for the fact that he put him back in that box.
Right.
I just couldn't randomly read the question.
We thought about that. We actually thought about putting it to where, like, because we're using the box to actually hold the camera up. We're going to fix stuff later. I'm not worried about right now, but we're going to fix it later. And next time, if we do that, we'll go ahead and take the cards out and read like a question to you guys and see who gets it right. And I can actually gift, channel points to people that do that. I can do it as my own stream. I can actually gift channel points to that. If I get it right, I can do that kind of shit. So I might do that. That might be something that if anybody was wanting to do that, I can do that. Cause I'm a big horror buff all the way back to fucking the 30s, even though, you know, just don't call me late for supper. I didn't even say because I was talking to you. I was like, what? What am I missing? Call me late for supper.
Yeah. Just don't call me late for supper.
Right.
That's an old joke.
Right.
Remember that joke when I was a kid?
So monotone. But let's see. The way I see it is to follow someone just because of what they play, you're following for the wrong reason. Yes, facts. Follow for the atmosphere they make in a stream, regardless of what they play on stream. Follow them for exactly. I've been saying that for a long time.
Well it's I true agree. Because, you know,
that's why I get a lot of followers.
Nine times out of ten, video game, it can only last so long.
Yep. I mean, look at the games that we were playing, four years ago, aren't being played as much and not near as many viewers. Look at Vanguard, for instance.
Granted, the D&D community out there.
That's big.
Yeah, the D&D community out there, they'll play their games, and I mean, it's literally storytelling anyways.
It's
because the one I watched, the one I was watching,
yeah,
they were playing the same kid. They were playing the campaign over the course of our life in real life, 5 years.
Okay, nice. See, I don't play D&D. Like, I have played D&D before. Like, I have played it. It's just not my cup of tea, but the one thing that I do with D&D is I enjoy to watch it. I enjoy watching because, like, some of these people play D&D on stream, and it's actually like a virtual D&D where you can see the characters do movements and stuff, and I'm like, that is really cool.
You can watch that stuff. I like to listen to the one I watch because, you know...
I'll listen to it, too.
No offense. They don't have those type of things where, you know... Stuff's really happening on screen.
Right, yeah.
They're listening to a talk. Yeah, so yeah. I'd rather listen to it in a podcast format.
Right. But like I said, and if you guys have any suggestions or stuff you want us to talk about, I mean, you're more than welcome to put suggestions in the chat, because I'll go through the stream after we're done and all that, because I'm only using Streamlabs while we do this, because it's a lot more user-friendly. Easier way to put stuff up and everything else like that, so that's why I'm using Streamlabs for this. But once I go back to streaming my own stuff, when I go back to OBS, so I gotta re-switch shit back over. Blah, blah, blah. But yeah. Blah, blah, blah. It's annoying, but it's not. It's just something I gotta get used to. So, but again, like, what was it? We were talking about, so this happened the other day too. It wasn't even the other day, it was yesterday. So Dilla comes over and we're chilling and hanging out and watching
and farting.
So I have a bad habit of laughing so hard to where my back hurts. Like literally to my back hurts. Yeah, what did with D&D I could watch it be played, but yeah, that's the way that I am. I can't play it. I it's not that I get bored. It's extremely complex for me, and I'm like, yeah, I'm good.
Well, you also got to think, there's a lot of math involved.
There is, and I'm like, yeah, no. Nope.
And math is not necessarily a forte.
No, it's not. Oh, I finally got two more clips after the one you made. Awesome, dude. Awesome. Yeah, always go through your streams. Make sure you have it set to where you can make the clips and stuff. It's set up towards up for 2 weeks that we can go through your streams, because everybody thinks it's weird. I'll watch my entire stream over to make sure I have clips made, and that's what I do. I do it with his as well. That's why he has clips, like the ones you saw at that's kind of like our intermission screen, is the video sort of thing. Those are clips that were from TikTok that I had made for him and made for myself, and just put a collage of them together, and that's how I did it. So always make clips when you can.
Notice that in the clips, I will not be featured.
Yeah, he won't be in camera. He doesn't have a camera. So, but you can hear him.
I don't have a camera. This here is pretty much me ever on a camera.
Yep. And like I said, if you guys go to the YouTube channel, like, we have our first podcast put on that one. And I'm going to try my best to figure out the Spotify thing and put this on Spotify as well. And I do want to get topics once in a while and figure out, like, other things to talk about. But, of course, we're going to end up going and off topic and then come back to it like we always do. Like, that's just what happens to us.
Yeah, we go off on tangents.
Exactly. This is why it's called that. Literally. Another finisher and a nice two-piece with the SP-80. Nice. Oh, the SPR. Did I just talk about the SPR? That marksman rifle. SPR. I think that's what he's talking about. SP-80. I don't know, but that's awesome, dude.
It sounds like a gun I won't use.
Right, yeah, most likely.
Mainly because I am not a semi-auto type of person.
I am when it comes to, like, certain rifles and stuff. Like, the lever action is, of course, my favorite, because I talk about it all the time. We play that one map, it's always that rifle.
The main reason is it takes forever for me to line up a shot.
It does happen. It does. But, yep. So that's what this is all about, this new thing that we're going to be doing. And we will be having guest stars as well. So, guys, keep that in mind. There will be guest star spots open for y'all to do that. It's the other one, Elder Battle Rifle or a Marksman Rifle. Yeah, the bolt action set. That's the SPR. Yep, I know what you're talking about. Yep, that's the one Sage would use on a daily basis. He loves that one. Especially an MW1.
You know what one Moses likes to use? The one with that lever action.
I didn't just say that. That's what I said.
I know.
That's my favorite one. Since MW1.
Why do you think I repeated it?
My favorite. You know? Exactly. But, my God, dude. So, again, what I was saying earlier today, he comes over hanging out. We're getting stuff set up, trying to find a table these damn fucking mics will clamp to. Couldn't find any. We found one finally. And on the border crossing map was, oh God, with the border crossing map, damn, that's crazy. That's insane. Walk out of the backside. Yeah, because they wouldn't see you. Pop, knock them off.
For me, border crossing, it's like I'm either gonna go down the freaking sides things or the side road, because
don't go down the center.
Going down the center is a pain in the butt because of the fact of so many cars, which means there's going to be crap tons of stuff in the way.
Exactly, yeah. But, so he comes over, and I have to bring this up. I have to.
I know.
It's just messed up. So.
It's just that sickness keeps making us go into a tangent about something else.
So, but yeah, so... because this will bring up another topic as well. So we're outside, yes, we're having a cigarette,
passing gas.
It literally, yes. So, he's in the middle of just like straight talking. We're talking and stuff, and they either blow him up or can't. Yeah, exactly. Yes, that's another way to get rid of him. Shoe fly, boom, explode. But so we're outside talking, and mid sentence, this dude doesn't miss a beat, literally just keeps talking. He rips a big one and just still keeps talking like it didn't happen. I couldn't help but laugh. About?
You are laughing at the fact that I am standing there having a conversation with you, ripping it and talking at the same time like it's not going on.
He didn't stop at all, just even push it out. It's just like it came out.
He was laughing so hard he was literally bent over.
Because when I laughed really hard, my back hurts. I told him, I was like, stop, my back hurts. And the problem is it was in my head and it kept replaying the fart. I couldn't stop laughing. I was like, my back hurts so bad. Because it was so bad.
It was hilarious.
Yes. You're quite the comedian, you know.
Well, but, of course I'm a commodian. You
commode, bro.
My favorite place to sit is the toilet.
It's the porcelain throne. So, since he farted, let me bring up a story that I did to Dillo. And it was an accident. It seriously was. It was not on purpose at all. This was not on purpose, all right?
In case you're wondering, this is the gas passing portion of the show.
So... We're going to Walmart, parks the car, and we're going to Walmart, and he parks the car, right? And I'm like, okay, we are best friends. I've known this man for over a decade, dude. Especially now, it's been 2023 now.
And we've grown closer after farting
on together. Bros that fart together stay together, you know? Exactly. But...
And you're gonna be lying to yourself if you don't turn.
I thought I said slothy unsubscribed. I was like, what?
She resubscribed.
Hell yeah, with the resub, let's go, slothy. Sickness, give me a shout out for slothy, please, if you could. Thank you so much. I do not have the clip thing added because that would be a lot of crap up there. What was that? I was wondering what that was. I couldn't figure it out. I was like, what's that noise? But yeah, give a shout out to Sloppy for me.
It's sickness fart. Yeah,
sickness. That's a sick ass fart, bro. So anyway, so we're he's parking the car at Walmart. And I'm getting ready to get
in the car.
Farting in the car at Walmart. And I'm getting ready to get out of the car. We're
piddle farting around trying to get out of the car.
We're old and fat. Like, we're both old. And so we're getting out of the car. And I didn't realize he was bent down getting his phone
in the center console.
His head is like right on my ass, like almost literally, like right inches from the crack.
What was that trying to be?
What's that, my dudes? Missed you, Moses. Smack Dillo's forever for me. Will do. Yes, never smack. So. I'm getting out of the car, and I had a fart built up, but I was just like, I was going to hold it. I was going to be holding the cheeks till I got out of the truck or out of his car. My leg slipped, and it let the fart out. And I mean, it was bad. It was like if your head was that close, it would turn your hair green. All right. And I just ripped it, and
Why do you think I'm bald?
His face.
This motherfucker blew my hair away.
His face was right there. And he's like, dude, you farted on me. I'm like, what? I look back and his head was still down. He's like, man, what the fuck?
And once again, he's practically bent over on the ground, dying of laughter while I'm dying of fart residual.
It was horrible. He's sitting there going, dude, what the fuck? And I felt bad, but then I started laughing.
Godzilla's atomic breath is bad.
No, that ain't shit.
Be behind Moses's ass.
Godzilla ain't got shit on me when it comes to that at all. But it was so bad. I felt bad, but at the same time it was funny. Because the same thing, like if it was to happen was to funny. Me.
It wasn't your face.
But I mean, if he did it to me, which he has, but if he did it to me, like, I'm gonna be like, what the fuck? But at the same time, I'm gonna be laughing about it. I wouldn't be able to help myself but laugh. Like, I'd have to. So, that was our fartscapade for those 2 days. That one was a while ago, though. This his fart was recent. His was bad. And I mean, I didn't smell it. It was just loud.
That's because we were outside. Loud. I was still in my car when you let yours off. Fucking crop dust in my car.
So bad. I mean, I felt
like... and worst part is it was still summertime, so yeah.
Nice emotes. Nice.
Like him. Farts in my face and we closed the door, so that means we left it to stew.
Oh, it was stewing in there, man. It was bad.
Well, at least we had the windows down.
True. So there's some type of ventilation of some sorts. But it was crazy. It was crazy. So I'm glad to see you guys here and everything. Like I said, this is what it's like. And if you guys, like I said, I'll bring it up. If you guys have topics, please let me know. And Slothy is number one on the list to start with guest star. I'll be setting that stuff up soon. That way you can have guest star. And
I know. It should be more hideous.
Yeah. What? First time seeing Dillo's, and I gotta say, the face does not match. Can you tap on my phone? Gonna try to go. All right, have a good one. Have a good one, Harley. Thank you so much for having us.
Wish you luck. Appreciate it. Wish you luck in your
game.
Have
an amazing stream. Yes. Have fun. Have fun. I mean, I don't know. With Dillo's voice, like I've talked to him on the phone. I don't know how many fucking times. Like I don't know. But I kind of pictured it. I kind of pictured the bellowing.
Well, you're.
I mean, but I'm used to you though, so I mean,
yeah,
I couldn't
you're
even
used
say that.
To my ugliness.
What the fuck? That's not what I meant. I was gonna try to say something positive, man. Even sickness is like not at all. Oh my god, you guys, dude.
My initial plan was to actually have it.
Yeah,
where my mic was going to be in my face the whole
game.
Yeah,
he had it said, I'm like, dude, the things in your face is like just where I want it.
I was going to have it in my face the whole dang stream, so you just barely see my face.
You just had like this red light in between your face, and all you'd see is like two eyes. They wouldn't even know what you look like because you'd be like, what? The mic's in the way, you know? But...
I like to maintain the air of mysteriousness.
Nope, no more hiding, sir. That's right. No more hiding. No more hiding.
I will after this stream is done.
Yeah, and then he's like, I'm going to go home and play now. And you ain't going to see me. Because, I mean, once we get done, I got to flip-flop my damn HDMH. God damn it. The word.
HDMI.
HDMI cords. Yes, there we go. To flip-flop them again so I can use that monitor as my gaming monitor. So... I don't know what I pictured, but it wasn't that. Yeah, okay, so let me ask you this. All right, what did you picture when you heard Dillo's voice for the first time and you hear him talking? And because Sickness knows and Slothy knows, like, we've all played Call of Duty together.
Yes.
Yeah, we've all played Call of Duty together.
Call of Duty.
Games in general. And heard your voice.
Maybe they weren't expecting such an old man. I don't know. Or maybe they were expecting an older man.
Older man, what were you expecting, guys? Like, I want to know. I'm honestly curious. Like I said, I can't say much because I've known him for fucking what, 13 years ish.
Yeah,
2023 now, so about 13 years now.
Wasn't expecting a beard.
What? That's new. Really?
What?
I mean, you listen to me, and I've got a higher pitched voice than you.
As long as he's known me, when I started off, I had a goatee.
He did. He had a goatee. He did not have the full beard. He had a goatee. Which, it's been a minute since you've had that. Because you've kept the beard for what? Past 5 years?
At least. Like
5 years?
I've had the beard ever since when November was actually not what it's now called.
Oh, God.
When it was called No Shave November.
Right. I like, honestly, a banjo strum.
Man.
Yeah, that's more me, though. That's the sad part. That's more me. But the voice he say, it, he picks
come on down.
It's like sickness. Find us a banjo sound now. Get us a banjo blurp.
Yes.
That would be hilarious. That would be funny. I'm serious. It would be funny. And they're all trying to catch Pokemon at the same time.
I don't do chewing tobacco.
I used to, not anymore. I'm losing my teeth. I don't need that shit. I'm good.
I actually tried it once.
You did?
Made the mistake of swallowing.
Oh, God.
And ever since then, nope.
When that shit happened to me, it was horrible. He's got the slow. I could see that.
The reason probably that happened is because.
On my back.
For four years, I had a boss who. Literally had a southern accent.
Oh, wow. Haven't smoked a cigarette in
a year and a half, but does vape.
Oh, I know she vapes. That's good. That's good, Harley. Hell yeah. I mean, we're right here with you. This is my new one, too, by the way. I'm going to be doing a review on this, by the way. This is the Geek Vape B60. 60 watts.
And this is my Christmas present from him. God
damn it. If I could, it better come off right. Fuck. There we go. Got it. It's just caught on camera, right? Whole pod thing here. Bam. It's magnetic. And why the hell did it take so... It was so hard to get off. Don't even.
I bet that's the first time that's ever happened for her.
Right. That's good, yeah. Next, we got to get to see... You could have seen Sickness's face. We were playing... Role models. He took a picture of himself for the character. Yes, Mr. Mime is me, is mine.
And then what next? Arctic.
I've seen Arctic. Yeah. Bro, look at yes. That's right. I told you guys we were doing it. Let's get a shout out for the wrong show, please. Let's do that. I told you guys that we were repping it. I wasn't playing. Like for real. I told you I wasn't playing. We were gonna be repping it. Yeah.
You know, looking on my thing, it looks like a Christmas thing.
Are you serious?
Does green it and red.
Oh, it does. Yes. Nice shirts. I love it.
Yes.
But yeah.
Now, what other fart stories do we have?
Do we have too many fart stories? We like 8 hours here just talking about farts. Literally, like that's what it would be.
Talking about farts.
Talking about
movies.
Farts. Movies is where it's usually at. Like, all right, let's go with that. Like. For instance, you already know who my favorite slasher is. It's actually a tie between Jason Myers. Well, it's not. I fucking hate that douchebag. I don't. Let me take that back because I know a lot of my friends are Michael Myers fans, and no disrespect, y'all like him. That's cool. But Jason Voorhees and Pinhead are tied for me. They're tied for me. It's so close, like that.
But of our past nostalgic of slasher movie characters.
I took the pot out. But
the slasher movie characters.
Who is this?
Freddy was done the worst.
Then the remake was horrible. Like, that's my opinion.
Why do you
on
think
this?
I said done the worst?
Yeah.
I mean,
because they need remakes. The other ones
even between Rob Zombies and these new ones,
right?
They're at least watchable.
Yeah, and the newest were way better. They did such a good job.
Even that Friday the 13th movie, that's
the Rob Zombie one.
No, Friday the 13th movie, the one that was basically like a reboot.
Oh, the Final Cut. I know what you're talking about. Yeah, I have that movie.
I don't think it was called Final
Cut. No, they have a Final Cut version of it called Final Cut. I know what you're talking about, though. The picture I'm just holding is machete
the
like
one,
this.
The one with the guy from Supernatural in it.
Oh, Jerry Padalecki. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah. It just says Friday the 13th.
Yeah. It just says
that one wasn't that bad either.
Exactly.
And then you look at the ones that put the Pepsi down. They're nasty. Oh, jeez. Nasty.
I'll drink whatever I want.
Yeah, see, look. I'm not drinking water. Hell no.
I ain't drinking water. I want some taste in my drink.
Yes.
He got it.
Did he do it? It was sickness. Beer. 100%.
No.
See, he don't drink. All right, so I was going to do this.
Because sorry, but beer drinking got ruined for me because of roommates who wanted to play nothing.
If you want taste.
Well, I'm not drinking energy drinks. I'm not drinking
juice.
Yeah,
he doesn't drink a lot of caffeine. He doesn't, which I understand. I get the reasons why. Drink caffeine like crazy. Like, I do.
I can't drink energy drinks anymore because my body feels like it's trying to pull itself apart. It's trying to speed up and slow down at the
beta
exact
alanine
same
in
time.
It. You get a high amount of beta alanine in it, dude. It makes you gives you fucking your like prickliness and all that. Fuck that shit, bro. No, nope. But like, I love beer. I love beer. And one of the times we do this, like this, like I told everybody, this will be happening. At least we're gonna try to do it every other week.
I'm sorry if I did drink beer, Budweiser.
You heard it. Not just me. Budweiser is my favorite beer. It's my Budweiser is my go-to beer. Now, if I want to be fancy with beer, I'd have to really think of what
Miller Lite is my father's favorite.
Really?
Yes. So much so that Rusty Wallace was his race car driver.
Really?
Yes.
Nice. Okay.
Of course, my grandfather's favorite race car driver was Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Hell yeah. You mean senior?
Well, both of them.
Okay.
Probably.
I mean, senior and junior are my favorite as well when I was watching NASCAR. When I was. Don't watch it anymore, but I did. Stewart, another good one with Stewart. Yep. What's his fucking name?
Everybody hates him.
All the rednecks hate him. Because he enunciates. I got a picture of Jeff Gordon, that fucker. I don't like Jeff Gordon. I can't stand him.
Oh, come on.
Do it for Dale, baby. He calls him Jeff Gordon. He enunciates. He's too proper.
I mean, come on.
You're a redneck sport, bro.
I mean, Dale Earnhardt respect him when he won his first Daytona 500 with a elk.
Right. Like, who the fuck does that in NASCAR?
What? Cheer somebody
with milk? Come the fuck on, bro. Grab a goddamn beer and be a man. Or woman, whatever, but yeah.
Well, yeah, I think.
Gotta have
congratulations,
milk.
Kid. You get to the big leagues.
I just love how it's up there. Jeff Gordon.
Well, it's just...
Every time. Raise hell, praise Dale. Exactly. I haven't drunk anything since last night, and I'm sure what y'all talk about because I missed something, but I have always been a Dale fan. Yes. Yes. Dale and Mark Martin. Yep. Yep.
Well, my father switched to Mark Martin after Dale Rusty retired.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. Raise the Red Bulls.
Oh, can't do Red Bulls.
Yo. See, they weren't that bad back in the day. Like caffeine wise, they weren't as strong. Now I looked at one of the cans and I'm like, that's a lot more than it used to be. It used to be like 80 milligrams of caffeine for them tiny little pussy cans, you know?
That's the thing I don't like is they're tiny little cans.
Over three bucks for a little thing this big.
I might as well get one of your cans for that. for that price. If I want to
get one free.
If I want to drink, I want something that's bigger than a shot glass.
Goddamn right. But speaking of beer, all right. Wrong show brought it up. I will be doing one of the shows that we do. I will be having alcohol on stream. I will. But I'm not going to have, like, I couldn't do the Slammus, dude. I'd kill myself. I haven't drank like that in a long time. I found this alcohol, this Mountain Dew with alcohol in it. It's delicious. I love it.
You're more than likely go for...
The regular Mountain Dew flavor was good. And it's zero on top of it. Zero sugar, all that shit. I don't like sugar in my drinks. Like, my energy drinks have sugar in them. I can't stand sugar. It's disgusting. It's my opinion, though.
He doesn't go for the sugar because I'm all the sweetness he needs.
You didn't like them?
Wow.
See, but I don't like seltzers. I don't, well, I've had one type of seltzer so far, and I can get slapped for it. I know I would. I've had it Truly before. Problem is I had one, and it tastes like fucking juice. And I was like, that's not good because I'm going to get drunk as fuck. Horrible. So I had one, and I love pineapple, so I tried it.
Definitely not.
I hate seltzers, but those were almost the worst ones. You talk about the Trulies, or are you talking about the Mountain Dews? Wrong show.
You know what I was thinking of doing as I was heading here?
What?
I would get, since
like
I was
TV static. All the MDs? Yeah. Okay.
I was thinking of
Mountain Dews.
When I was getting these, and I was thinking of just because for the Wrong Show, I was going to grab some White Claws.
Oh, God. Now, here's the thing. The Claw of Death. So I'm not trying to, like I said.
You don't have a mug.
I don't have a mug of death. I don't got none of that, man. And I respect them so much. They're fucking awesome. I love them. And but I will have beer on the show one day. I will have my 12-pack next to me. Either it's going to be Mountain Dew or it's going to be Budweiser, man. One of the two. I don't care what it's going to be.
I provide all the sugar.
Yeah, right here, man. All the sugar right here, baby. All the sugar you can get. There's enough for all of us here. All of us to go around.
But I will have beer eventually. Sure, Surge. Yeah, I've had Surge.
Surge was good, dude. I mean, that's the one drink that I had that brings me back to the 90s was Surge. And that was like my go-to. Like, I had Mountain Dew, and then Surge came out, and I was like...
Surge was the... Coca-Cola equivalent to Mountain Dew.
Right. But to me, Surge tastes better.
But I was more of a Mellow Yellow man.
I like Mellow Yellow too, though. You know, I like it too.
Ugh.
When they brought it back, though, it did taste different. Like, I had, when it brought it back, like, 5 years ago, 5-6 years ago, they brought back Surge. Because I was doing a paper route, like, every 7 days a week, I was doing a paper route starting at midnight. Got the papers at 1:30 in the morning, then started doing the route. And they brought Surge back, and I was like, oh my God, I got to get me, because they only came in, like, you know, 16 ounce cans. So I was like, I got to try it. So because I saw it, I'm like, all right, let's get it. Got that, got my energy drink, got snacks, shit. All right, time to go get the papers. I cracked the thing open in the road and in the car, and I'm like, this is not the same. It doesn't taste the same that I remember when I was younger. But like I said, I'll be 35 in less than a week. You know, and that's not what I remember it tasting like at all. So I agree. It did taste. It was way different. It was way different. But yeah.
But then again, a lot of the drinks when we were kid are not the same as what they are now.
Oh, yeah. Like, none of them. Shoot. Go for it, Slothy. The price of beef jerky.
Too high.
Oh my God, dude. Speaking of beef jerky, like she said, the price of beef jerky. All right. So I was at the gas station the other day. I think both of it was either I walked there, I think it was with him.
Yeah.
And you had mentioned it too. This fucking bag of beef jerky, like regular big size, like, yeah, it's $22 or $24 for this bag of beef jerky. And I'm like,
I can make
this shit at home.
It better be embedded with gold flakes in there for that price.
And fucking straight ribeye. It better be what it fucking is. This shit was expensive. Yeah, the fucking price of everything is insane now. But beef jerky alone, like, I was at the gas station looking at stuff, and I remember beef jerky being like $6 for, you know, a decent sized bag. And then I'm looking and I'm like, This is $16 more than I remember it ever being. $16, and I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? Seriously.
Yeah.
Like, this is a joke.
Nope,
not a joke. This is real life. Reality sucks.
But at least home, at least now at home, I got my adult Easy Bake Oven.
So explain your adult Easy Bake Oven. Explain that.
It's an air fryer.
It's fucking awesome. And I want one. And he got the last one that was on sale. Literally. The last one.
For the black, for that Black Friday deal.
You can shove that, you can shove it up a chicken's ass and fucking rotisserie that shit.
I can rotisserie.
Oh my god, dude. Oh my god, I want one. Have you seen the, yes. Oh my god, Slothy, yes. Eggs. We were just at fucking Walmart. The day that we went down the memory lane.
He complains about it every time we walk by that thing.
Okay, so back when I was going to the gym a lot and I was eating a lot of protein, so I was going through eggs nonstop. I bought 18 packs, dual 18 packs at a time, because I would eat 3 egg omelets twice a day, or just protein in general, and I use eggs a lot. So
right.
Back then, an 18 pack of eggs was only like $2 and some change, like $2.07 for an 18 pack. I was like, okay, that's fine. Or $1.77. Let me take that back. $1.77. I haven't been to the gym in a long time, so I've been wanting to go really bad. And it's been a couple years. And so I go back and look at eggs. I'm looking at the 18 pack that we were looking at. $7. Yeah. And I was like, what in the actual fuck is going on? Like, $7 for 18 eggs. And or was it the 2-pack? I don't think it was the 2-pack. Was it?
Those chickens better be laying golden eggs.
It has begun. But the price of eggs is astronomically changed to, like, for the worst. Because I remember a gallon of milk being 88 cents. I remember fucking eggs being 70 cents for an 18 pack, 70 cents. I remember that.
I was reading that wrong.
Dildo.
The Pokemon that escaped. I thought it said Dillo escaped.
Dillo escaped.
Ah.
No comeback. The price of everything. Yeah, price of everything is ridiculous. It doesn't matter. And it kind of, yeah, we're just shot. It's over. Like, there's nothing we can do about it.
What are you going to change? You don't need a Ditto, Slothy.
You need a Dillo. You need a Dillo. Not a Ditto, a Dillo. Okay.
Meanwhile, we both look like Snorlaxes from the original Twins. Pokemon game.
He just has less hair than me. That's the only difference. And he's got a couple years on me. That's pretty
got
much
less
it.
Hair on my head. I probably got True. More on my body.
I don't know, man. Might be a close tie.
We're not gonna find out.
Well, yeah, let's not find out about the body hair issue. But
that, and also it goes against
Yeah, you gotta be careful what you do now, because you don't hurt nobody's feelings on everything, you know. But anyways, so to the wrong show if you're still here. This is what you're gonna look like if you let yourselves go, and it's like 10 years from them now.
Yeah, this is what happens when the beer gets to you.
Exactly, economy sucks ass. But yes, this is we were talking about this. Like, we wore the merch and stuff, and I was excited to bring you guys into it with the shows, with the shirts and stuff. I've already let myself out. Not even close, bro. This is letting yourself go. You just let it slide a little.
This is when the beer finally catches up to you.
Yes. But yeah, so we decided like that I would be the Commodore. That would be me. Because when he said he wore glasses, I was like, dude. Because, you know, Jack Lombardi wears glasses, you know, on stream and stuff.
And
so.
He has the beard, too.
Exactly. But I don't have just the
staff.
But
my beard, granted, my beard's not as long as Jack Lopes is. So and like, my hair isn't either.
We brought that up. Like, this would just be them if they let themselves go. It cracked me up.
Yeah.
But, yeah. I appreciate it, man. And you have no idea. Like, I tell him all the time. Like, I fanboy over you guys. You guys are so awesome. You guys have got me. Because we've been talking about doing this for over a year. Like, literally doing, like,
I know,
just talking about shit for
he's
over a year.
He's gone off on his own tangents
about it. And like I finally was like, you know, we need to do this. We need to finally step up and do this and do it for once. And we finally did. And I love it. I mean, this is the first time we've seen Dillo on camera. Well, y'all have seen Dillo on camera. He comes over all the time. Literally, like, with Jackalope and Commodore, like, you know, they're close, you know? He is literally, like, a 2 to 5 minute drive from my house. So,
well, it's like a little bit more right now because the direct route to his house is under construction.
Still.
For half over a 6 months. Year.
Yeah, over 6 months, and it's just to do one little strip. And it's like, what the fuck are you guys doing? Oh, let's make another roundabout.
Man, fuck roundabouts.
I can't stand them. This isn't, you know, Europe, you know?
Roundabouts are, in my opinion, roundabouts are dumb.
I mean, I agree.
But they're trying to keep
the flow of traffic going. I get that, but it's not
yeah,
working.
Yeah, but it's not. It's not.
Then again, I don't drive legally, so yeah. Thank you.
Yes.
Exactly. Dumb. What's wrong with four-way stops and stoplights?
Exactly.
Because a lot of the newbie drivers don't understand how the roundabout works. They don't, and that's what caused a lot of accidents recently here where we're at. Caused accidents at the roundabout because they didn't realize, hey, I got to slow down and wait a minute for somebody to come through. Right. Because they have the right-of-way to continue. We have to stop. Oh, we don't get that, so they just keep going and fucking nail somebody. I watched it happen, and I'm like, wow, that just happened.
Like, am I supposed to get out of here? Am I supposed to go?
I watched a dude in his pickup truck. I mean, yeah, his pickup truck. And
well,
he jumped over the fucking thing.
Those guys in their pickup trucks love their donuts
fuck
anyways.
That shit. I'm going over it. But he did. And his pickup truck went over the roundabout and said, fuck it. Just went over it. He's like, fuck this shit, you know?
Yeah, because it's like, now you're wasting, you know, your tires because you're trying to go around it.
I've watched a guy go around a damn roundabout 4 times just to go straight. I don't know if he didn't know what he was doing or if he was lost or what. He went around the roundabout 4 times just to go straight. And there was nobody in his way. Literally, nobody was in his way. It's not like there was a bunch of traffic. It was literally him and 2 other cars. And I'm like, what are you doing? Because I'm behind him. And, you know, my father-in-law is driving. Truck. We just got done.
Speaking of what are you doing? Parkour.
All right. So, you know, we were playing Call of Duty one day when we were playing Vanguard, right? You know, of course, because Vanguard was so long ago.
Yeah.
Not. And so we're playing Vanguard, and I'm watching him. He's in front of me. His character's in front of me, and I'm running, sprinting, you know. And he's like, he goes onto a rail, then jumps off and goes right back the same path he was going before. And I'm like, what are you doing? He goes, parkour. And I start laughing. I'm like, okay. And then I see him do it again. He's like, as he's doing, he goes, parkour. And I start laughing. I'm like, what are you doing? He's like, parkour. Like, what the fuck, dude?
What it is it has automatic I have automatic mantling
mine
on.
Mine isn't set up like that. Double tap.
That's my issue.
Yep.
Too much times of trying to double tap gets annoying to me because 9 times out of 10, I'm trying to run forward. My guy won't go forward because he somehow magically gets stuck on an invisible wall.
Right. Oh, there's a wall here? No, but you still get stuck.
Yeah.
You know? And like I said, everybody, you guys remember about to bring up topics.
So half the time, he'll see me trying to run upstairs with rails, and I'm like jumping from rail to rail because
I thought he was being like professional about the shit. Like he knew what he was doing. Like, damn. Oh, no, this is an accident. Parkour. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? It's insane. But yeah, so it's crazy. But I think that, you know, once one of us can afford it, we definitely got to get that Blockbuster thing to put in the frame. That'd be
right.
Because like I said, memory lane was badass. Seeing that Blockbuster thing literally looked like it was just a video cassette somebody left there on accident until you saw there was more of it.
And since it was able to be opened, you open it and it has a cardboard instruction thing that looks like a video cassette.
Yeah, yeah. That was my mistake there. There we go. I knew I made a mistake.
You are.
I am a mistake.
Some of us could all say that we are a mistake,
right? Anyways, but yeah.
I mean, they threw that into a Powerpuff Girls episode.
Oh my god, yeah. That was crazy. You're a mistake. Sure.
No, wait. The girl's like we were made in a lab by accident by the professor. And she's like, that's okay. I'm an accident too.
The fuck was that? Scared the shit out of me.
How can it scare the shit out of you?
Daddy, yes. I mean, I didn't realize it because we're talking and I'm not thinking about it, and it boom, hops on. I'm like, oh shit. But yeah. See, now you have to bring up some stupid shit that's happened. Stuff happens all the time.
Always.
And it's usually, like I said, Wachowski. He comes over, like I said, almost every night after work, he comes over because he works second shift. So he's done, you know, at like 11 o'clock at night. He comes over around midnight-ish, around that time. Because we're Eastern Standard Time, so yeah. Just that way you guys know our time zone.
Yes.
Because it's so important-ish, not... Yeah. He comes over and, you know, we sit there and talk for a while. And what happens is, like, I always say, I'm going to get ready to stream at this time. And there was a time that he came over and I even said, you know, I'm going to stream and stuff like that, right? So everybody knew I was going to stream. And we're talking, you know, he got me energy drinks and stuff. And I cracked one open and I'm talking to him.
I brought him energy drinks for his streaming.
Yeah, for the stream. And then, that's back when it was the usual.
And yeah.
So it was 200 drinks and a Mountain Dew Zero. Yeah.
It was two bangs.
Oh, God. Blue Raz. Not fond memories for that one. I'm so blue razzed out, dude. It's unreal.
I was almost thinking to be a dick and bring the blue razz.
Oh, God. Oh, my God, dude. But he brought him over, and we're talking, and I cracked my first one open, and I'm drinking it. All right, cool. You know, we're relaxing.
High board.
I'm Moses. And so I pretty much finish it, and we're just talking and having our tangents. You know, it's summertime, so it's nice and warm out, so I'm not wearing a coat, worried about getting cold. And soon, we just started the conversation, it felt like, and all of a sudden we look up, and like, it's awfully bright out. What the hell? We look up, and the sun's coming up, and I looked at what time it was. It was 5:30 in the morning. So we were talking from midnight to 5:30 in the morning, and we're like, oh shit, we didn't know that. And I had to apologize for people in Discord that we literally were just talking, and it was an accident. We didn't mean to do it. I mean, literally, it wasn't on purpose. And that's what happens. That's why we do this. So you still like in the, yes. Actually, that's gone. I downed that bitch. That shit's gone, dude. It was good. Would you like to application some kind of dopamine into your, oh my God. Shut up. The Rocket Pop was really good. I downed that shit in what was it? I think I finished that whole tub in like 2.5 weeks, I think, roughly. Because I drank about 2 or 3 of them a day. My cup's sitting right over here. And, look at the hell. My watch went off. But literally, I drank that stuff in like 2.5 weeks. One tub. So I figured out how much it would last me because, you know me, with these alone, I drink 2 to 3 of these a day almost. So, yeah, lasted about 2.5 weeks for that one tub, but it was really good. I liked it. I did like it. So, I mean, I think Blood Orange was still better because when I had Blood Orange packet, that shit was really good.
For an orange.
Yeah, quite bloody, but it was good. But I still don't know what my favorite one is yet so far. Blood Orange so far, I think, takes the cake so far. I got a tub for my tub it myself and try to limit myself to one a day, but yeah, it's hard because it's good. Exactly. It is hard because it goes down, like this goes down a little bit harsher than regular drinks do because it's not carbonated.
Well, no, he's saying he's not really an orange flavored drink person. Not either, but blood orange actually tastes kind of good.
As this is orange as we speak. I didn't even think about that until now. I'm like, wait a minute, this tastes like orange.
Yeah, orange sherbet. Like, an orange sherbet.
Right. There was no sherbet in there. Yeah, it was just this one.
Mm-hmm.
But it's fine.
Yeah.
What time are you going to... I don't know. I knew this was going to happen.
Like, I knew.
So I said, grab everything you need. And GTFO. Pick a time. I don't know. I really don't.
I picked a time. Anytime.
Anytime. Yes. Anytime. Without the fitness. Midnight. Yes. Midnight. I don't know. I mean, we probably could talk till midnight.
If we really wanted to, we could probably talk till 6 in the morning.
It's no joke. We could. I'd be like, hold on, let me grab my medication real quick so I can take that. But I really don't know. Like, we have had it to the point where we've talked that long. I got one of four of my starters, and it was decent. I like it again, but okay. See, I have to push my glasses up all the time just to recheck because my eyes are so damn bad. Getting your channel points in there?
Yes.
I just saw that. He's like, yeah, channel points.
Yes, my channel points. Oh, 146 points.
Jesus Christ.
1K.
146,000?
Yes.
That's insane. And you've used some before, too. Like, yeah. Every once in a while. I still have that much? That's crazy. Remember, Sickness says he's going to try and beat you in Biddy, so we'll see what happens. Mind you, Sickness, Dillo has over 47,000 biddies total. I think it was 47,700 biddies total. It was crazy. Yeah. But, like, this is just the first episode. Like, I said, I'm definitely open to topics in Discord and stuff. Like,
right.
You can ask anything. Like, we talk about movies, anything like that. Especially with critiquing as well, is what we do really is most, is talking about films that we like and somewhat critiquing what they are, how good they are, how bad they are.
I mean, we could talk about us watching the Expendables movies.
Yeah.
When you wanted to stream, or when you were clicking a stream, and then I get home, check Discord, and there's Sickness and Swayman having a conversation about that he fell asleep in the chair.
Right.
The chair.
I do that. That does happen. I was planning on streaming one day. I sat down in my chair, and my chair is very comfortable. And
which is sitting just off screen.
Yeah, literally, it's like right over here. Right beside me, right here. And literally, I fell asleep in my chair. I wake up at like 5 o'clock in the morning, and I look at Discord, and I'm like, oh, crap.
Yeah, you look at Discord. You got some messages for also me, ate. Like, hey.
That's another problem. I also ate, so I was, like, full belly. Like, yeah, I just pass out in my chair. It happens all the time. It does.
Yes.
And I apologize to all of you, because I do fall asleep when I'm doing that. I do. I don't mean to. And that's why people in Discord now say he probably sat in his chair.
Yeah.
Because I fall asleep in a recliner all the time.
Well, I started that thing.
Yep. Well, he's probably sitting in his chair now.
Probably because he sat in his chair.
Yep. It's usually what it is, to be honest.
And he especially loves his chair because it's got the lazy button.
It does. There. It literally...
Where you hold a button and it slowly raises off the seat and leans it back on him.
Yep. It's an automatic chair. Like, reclines automatically by hitting the button. Descends by hitting the button. Like, it's crazy. That chair has made me so lazy.
I mean, heck, if you wanted to, you could hit the button to cause him to stand up.
Yeah. It actually helps you get out of the chair. It's for people that have issues getting up and down, older fellas and stuff like that.
I'm trying to convince him to let me have it.
It scared the shit out of me. I don't know why stuff scares me. I'm not used to it.
Right.
I'm not used to it. Because, like I said, I'm going to try and get this, because when I'm done doing this, I'm going to end up putting it on Spotify. I'm going to download it onto my computer and then figure out how to put it on Spotify, get a hold of a buddy of mine, put it on Spotify, make sure that the name that we're using isn't obviously trademarked or anything like that, or copyrighted, whatever. That way,
we can still use ours and say, boom, this is ours. We started that, you know?
And then I was checking on Spotify. There's like a dozen, there's a dungeon, dozen people with named Tangent Talk right. Show.
It was insane. I was like, I thought we were being original.
Apparently not.
Well, then again, nothing's original these days.
Yeah, you might as well go back to the 80s for that, too. Shit, probably farther back than that.
Yeah.
Really. I mean, look at fucking, what was it? Not Last Man on Earth. When the Earth Stood Still.
Well,
it was black and white. That was the original one.
Yeah.
That was way back.
Actually, Last Man... you said the Last Man on Earth. The giant horse cock
weighs over 11 pounds.
Ah.
Perfect time.
How many people while watching YouTube wake up to hearing that?
A giant horse cock.
I've actually seen that clip on YouTube.
Are you serious?
Well, no. Of a person that woke up to that. They're like, what the fuck?
You're awake now. Oh, my God. Insane. But, oh, my God. But yeah, I want to figure out how to get on Spotify the way it's official and everything. But we're going to try. I want to try to do this every other weekend. That way, because, you know, my kids won't be here at that time. I mean, my son's here this time, but kids won't be here. I can't read that. What's it say?
It says hydrate.
I wish it would show up right here, which drives me nuts that it doesn't. I'm going to end up, when we do this, I'm going to end up making that bigger.
Well, which is ironic because it shows up on my phone.
It does? Yeah, see? And it even says, join conversation with your phone. You don't have to hydrate because it's not your stream. See?
I'll do it.
He's like, you know what I'm going to do for you anyway.
That's another thing.
Hydrate. Right,
so he was, we were in the car.
Hail
hydrate. So we were sitting in the car. It would be best if he was not live. What?
She said she would do it to me, but I'm not live.
Right. So you can do it to him, I guess, if he allows it.
But then again, I also don't have that as redeem because I'm not affiliated.
Right, not affiliated. I forgot what I was saying. Oh, no. So
I'm just a pissy.
We got back from Walmart. And we're walking back to the car.
Which part?
When I was vaping and I went into my drink that time. Remember that? See? I didn't have to finish it. Already started. So... We're coming back from Walmart, or we're leaving Walmart, getting in the car, and what you pissing on? I don't know. Toilet.
You know what we're pissing on?
Pissant.
You know what we're pissing on? Electric fences.
Not piss on.
We're gonna piss on electric fences.
Hell yeah. But
nothing like a thrilling.
Bulk of electricity to the balls. No balls. But we're sitting in the car because we got everything loaded up. And I was drinking a Mountain Dew Zero or something. I know it was Mountain Dew Zero something.
I think it was
Baja Blast that time when they actually had it?
Not sure. Not sure if it was the Baja. I think it might have been the ones you like now, the Spark, I think. Spark. It is.
Yeah. So I'm sitting there and I'm taking a drink in my pop and I'm like, oh, this is really good. And then I was like, wait a minute, let me try something. So I take a hit off my vape and then I put the drink in my mouth and you can see the vape just going out like this. And he just starts laughing his ass off. And I'm like, what's so funny? He's like, you're taking a drink and vape at the same time, it just goes like this.
Yeah.
It filled up my bottle.
Yeah, but you should have seen my reaction, though, because I'm setting my phone in my thing, put the phone in the thing. I'm noticing out of the corner of my eye, he's taking a drink, and there's smoke billowing out, and I'm halfway through it, staring at him like, the fuck are you doing?
It's one of those things you just had to be there to see it, like, what the fuck? You know, it's one of those you have to be there to see it. It was insane. How high were you? There you go.
I'm never question for high. You.
He doesn't do that. Really, he doesn't. I mean, it'd be more accurate if I did it, but I don't even do it. I would be more likely to do that than you would.
I don't because my fact is my work has a stupid...
Yeah, true. High on life, there you go.
Yeah.
That's kind
I
don't of know.
It's kind an, of I think that's an alright video game.
Oh, I'm like trying to seriously read this and be like, what? And she's being sarcastic.
Oh.
It's Slothy.
Is she being... Well, she...
I don't know why no, she's she, laughing.
Well, Sapphire is...
But she's high, yep, she's high.
No, she's hangry.
Oh, I'm not... Oh, Sapphire.
Yes.
I don't know yet. Okay. But, yes, Slothy, you're always high. You could always do your Zoom thing, or your, what's it called? Arctic Zoom made it for Zoom. What was it? I can't remember.
Zoot.
Zooted. Zooted, there it is, yeah, zooted. I don't know if that's right, I don't believe that.
She's only
20% high. Only 20%
high,
you're not that high. Nope, that doesn't count. I forgot Arctic made that. I was like, I can't remember who did it, or what it was called, because I don't do it. I was looking at the screen as you're going like this. I'm like, what's he doing? I forgot I'm sitting right here. Pretty accurate. I haven't smoked yet. Just hitting dab. Nice. Well, then you can do it when you're done hitting the dab pen. Then try it one more time. And then see what happens.
I'm sorry, but the word dab is ruined for me.
I think he said something about that before. How it was ruined for you.
Well, dab is ruined for me because of that stupid crap.
That dance or whatever the fuck you want to call it. There, I had to refresh this. Let's see. Eye on that too. There, I'm trying to figure everything out because something's fucked up. Now.
What's fucked up?
My phone is like frozen on something. There
That's
you go.
Because... It's back.
I refreshed it. I was looking at something.
Yay.
High on a hangover. Damn. Oh, that would suck. I got, because I was drinking on New Year's, because I don't drink that often, but when I do, I drink, I used to. But I actually drank this New Year's, I actually did, and,
I didn't.
I know you didn't.
No, I sat all alone, watching YouTube.
You make that so mopey. I sat alone, watching YouTube.
Well, that's exactly how everybody's going to take it, too.
Just sat alone watching YouTube.
Well, actually, no, I take that back. I wasn't watching YouTube. I was watching Twitch.
Oh, were you?
Yeah. You know, my favorite person.
Right. Yeah.
Because he was doing the...
Was he doing New Year's?
Yeah. It nice. Was a New Year's and his 2-year anniversary.
Oh, it was it 2-year anniversary?
It was his 2-year
anniversary.
Yeah.
Nice.
He started right on New Year's for 2019 to 2020.
Wow. Yeah. Damn. I had to go back because I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I think I started in 2019, I think. I started streaming when I got into this house, which I think was 2000. Beginning of 2019. No, it was in the summer. It was October. Something I don't remember. 2019 is all I know. Is when we got into the house, and that's when I started streaming. Because I originally started on YouTube. Because everybody kept telling me, "Oh, you got to do YouTube," because it's better than Twitch is. I didn't know much about Twitch at the time, and I'm like, "Well, I'll try YouTube." And I was also doing vape reviews and product reviews and stuff on YouTube, which I'll do that. Dinner options because I don't want Sapphire to kill us. I'm gonna get a headache. I really am. But I forgot what I was saying. This is what I hate about short-term memory loss, dude.
I forgot what I was saying. I literally forgot what I was saying.
I didn't. You're saying either.
I wasn't even listening. Like, yep, okay. But yeah, I forgot. That's out. I forgot what I was saying. I've only had a hangover once, one time, and it was when I was 14. Drank a big ass bottle. Damn. So yeah, New Year's. That's what it was. Yeah. So I drank on New Year's, but I mean, I didn't get shit faced or drunk or nothing. But I drank more than I normally do because the shit goes down like water, and I was like, oh no, this is gonna be bad. So I had
when I used to work for this restaurant. Everybody that was over the age of 21 for Christmas got a case of beer.
What?
Yes.
And I take that shit. I love beer. Huh. Beer's good.
I also remember that every payday we'd go to one person's house, and then after we've all cashed our checks and start playing poker.
Hell yeah, dude. Poker was my shit back in the day. That's another thing we saw at fucking Memory Lane, dude, was a set of a poker set, dude, because it reminded me because I used to have a poker set. Literally, it was like an aluminum steel box, and you would open it.
Right.
It had chips in there, your cards in there, all your stuff. It was beautiful.
The clay chips.
$100 for that fucking set. Yeah. Had that, and then it got stolen. Gotta love that. Speaking of thieves, bro. All right. Sea of Thieves, right. Speaking of thieves, right? So I was, I had about the $900 worth of tools. And let's see, I need y'all to get closer so we could. I love to play poker, man. I love poker. I don't mind 21. I don't mind it, but I'm a regular poker player, dude. Like five card hand, you know, five card poker is what I play.
He likes five card stud.
Five card studs, what I like. Texas Hold'em. I can play Hold'em though. Like I can play Hold'em. I don't mind it, but it's not my favorite. It's not my favorite though. I don't mind it, but it's not my favorite. I'll play it for the hell of it and have some beers and shit, but that's it. Depends on
who's right.
Gotta love it. Gotta love it.
Yes.
The audience loves us. You know it. Well, some do. But yeah.
I don't know. I think I've shocked most of
everybody. Like, that's Dillo.
Yeah.
<They're> like, I wasn't picturing that.
Yeah, apparently they were expecting.
You in your overalls.
I knew
a bit of banjo with some wheat in your mouth. Full on redneck.
Like, I hold on, I gotta go milk the cows.
That's right. I ain't poker, just a random person.
Ah.
That was pretty good. Oh my god, dude.
No, he says, I ain't poking just a random person.
Oh. I told you my eyes are bad. Even with this big ass screen, I can't see shit.
Yeah.
It's bad. Like, I have a 75 inch TV in front of us that has a stream going right now, so I can read, and I still can't read.
At least it's not a 75 inch plasma screen TV.
Oh my god, do you remember those? Plasma screens, oh my god. So speaking of memory lane.
I've never had plasma.
I owned a plasma once. All right, I had a 50-inch plasma TV back in the day. Way back in the day. I was about 19 or 20, I think. I think it was 19. Back then, 50-inch was like top dog back then. 50-inch was big, all right? And plasma was a real big thing at the time.
Yeah, I bet it was big back then.
That's right, it was. It's gotten smaller over the years, but still.
Right.
But I had a 50-inch plasma TV. And my laptop at the time was connected to it, and it was only taking the 4.3 ratio of my screen, so the rest was black. I didn't know that it was going to burn. I didn't know it burned back then. I had no idea. So I finally, after...
They never mentioned that.
They never mentioned it. No, they didn't say, hey, this is going to happen if you fucking do that. It's gonna ruin your TV. We didn't tell you that, you know. So I went ahead, and after, I think, about two or three weeks of me using it like that with my laptop... I finally unplugged it and went to full screen. And I'm looking, and I'm like, why do I have two gray spots on the side of my TV? Why is it like that? It was burnt. So I went ahead and did the self-cleaning mode where it would turn white, go across, and supposedly supposed to fix it. I did that for like an hour. Because I was freaking out because I'm like, my TV's broken. Oh, shit. And I called. I was going to Rent-A-Center at the time. You know, my evil ex-girlfriend's Rent-A-Center pretty much. Because they still call me to this fucking day. I've got new numbers more than once. And they still get a hold of me. And
how they find out your new number.
Exactly. It's like fucking fortune-telling bullshit, you know. And so I went ahead and did that. And I called him. I said, look, you know, there's a burn spot in my TV. I don't know what's going on, blah, blah, blah. Okay, well, you know, we'll send somebody over. What do you mean send somebody over? What are they going to do? Magically tap it and it's going to fix it? It's burned. Oh, it doesn't work. Just the way the voice sounds to me. It sounds a southern... Get the draw. It actually looks like a buddy of mine. It's smaller for it.
Is he saying his friend has a smaller forehead or I had?
You have a smaller forehead, I think.
I don't know. I'm all forehead.
I can't, like I said, even with a big ass screen, I can't see. But I went ahead. They came over and looked at my TV. They're like, "Yep, that's burnt." I said, "Well, no shit, Sherlock." I'm like, I've been doing this for a fucking an hour trying to fix my goddamn TV. Of course, I know it's fucking burnt. And I said, "Well, what are we gonna do about it?" And like, "Well, you got to pay us $50 so we can give you another one."
Right.
And I said, "So I have to pay you for you to get rid of it to give us to give me another TV when it has insurance on it because wear and tear is technically on the like." I had to read him what the damn contract said, and I did. Right. And then I called him while he was sitting there, and I said, "This is what he's telling me, that I have to pay this much money," because back then $50 was quite a bit of money back then, because this was so long ago, and now $50 is a lot now because of fucking inflation. We'll get into that another day. But finally, he was like, "Oh, I was wrong." I'm like, "No shit." I'm like, "You're supposed to give me another one because this is wear and tear. It's all it is." And finally, I was like, "Do you guys have a different TV that we can use because it's plasma?" I said, "You guys have an LCD TV at the time. LCDs were obviously better because you look at it now, they don't burn as easy. You know what I mean? Right. They don't burn near as easy." And,
hey, look, Prinny showed up.
What's up, Prinny? On my buddy has like a 10 forehead and will tell you he does. Apparently, his buddy has a very big forehead. Apparently, he has a very big forehead.
That was a big, big head.
Yeah. But, needless to say, they finally got me new TV, and I switched from plasma to fucking LCD because that shit not burnt. I was so pissed when it burnt my TV because I was like, "What am I gonna do?" You know, because they're sitting trying to tell me that I wasn't getting a new one. And I'm like, "Fuck yourself."
Of course, also back then, they also thought plasma was gonna be the next big thing,
but it wasn't.
Yeah.
Fuck that. I mean, going back down memory lane, like, plasma TVs were nice and stuff, they were, but if you did not use it right or didn't take care of it, you were
screwed. Don't forget about the gimmick of the 3D TVs.
Oh, yeah, oh my God. When that first came out, that was like almost a decade ago when that was announced. And yeah, it was so annoying.
They tried to do it. It didn't work as well as they anticipated or something.
Apparently he has a big head. Ass won't fit his head.
Yes.
You tried my hat on. What was it yesterday? Tried my hat on. I said it didn't fit because it was too small.
Well, it didn't fit because somebody had a small head, so it was too tight.
Oh. But yeah, that was another thing down memory lane. Like, I liked plasma TVs and stuff when I finally learned how to take care of it. I did have another one at one time, and I took care of it. It lasted over a year, and you know, I obviously found a different TV that I liked more because we're still paying on it. And I'm like, "Well, I want this TV because I know it's better, looks nicer, costs less." And I'm like, "I'll take that one." And we switched out, and I got a different TV at the time. This was way back. This was before my kids were born. But then eventually, once, you know, where I'm at now, you know, 8 years ago, I ended up buying a Vizio, which, dear God, back then, Vizios fucking sucked. I couldn't stand them. I had the D-Class or D-Series Vizio, and that thing was a piece of shit. Like, yeah, it burnt and everything. It lasted 3 years total.
Always complained about the D-Series.
I complained about the D.
Yes, he did complain about the D. It just wasn't good enough for him.
Wasn't good enough. No, it wasn't. It wasn't good enough.
So, but I
so left. He switched to the B.
Exactly. Oh, I'll get a hold of you. I have your number. I'll get a hold of you. I have his number, right? I have your number. Yeah. But, what was it?
That's a nowhere you live.
I went back to, well, yeah. But that street.
Yeah, he also
right down the street.
Yeah. He also lives right down blocks the street. Away.
Yeah. But, shit. What am I saying? I'm saying something. Oh, the Vizio. I actually have a Vizio right now in my bedroom, but it's newer. So and I had, but also it was free, and I'm like, all right, well, I'll go ahead and take it because it's something I needed. I wanted a TV in my room. Because at the time, I was using a TV that wasn't mine, so I was afraid if I broke it, then, you know, I have to replace that. I'm like, I don't want that to break. So I finally got, you know, I got a TV from my son's mom. She's like, here, just take this one. You can have this one. Okay. And it's way bigger than what I had before. And I was like, and it actually works pretty well. Like, it looks nice. It works nice. I'm like, okay. And I asked her, I said, you know, am I gonna be able to keep it? Or am I gonna have to
give it back? LG is a lot better than Vizio.
LG is way better. LG is actually, if I had a choice, if I could just choose a TV out of any brand, I would have to say that I would go LG because LG has never let me down for TVs. LG's never let me down. Ever. Never let me down. And like Pretty stated, 10 years he's had the LG still working. Still working to this day.
But then again, Prenny is also the type of person that uses something until it no longer works.
Right. Right.
We've known him that long to know this.
Yeah. But like I said, I had an LG TV that lasted me 5 years, no problems. I just replaced it with Samsung. Started going Samsung, and then one of my Samsung TVs broke on me. Then I went to Hisense TVs because it was cheap. And it was a Android TV because I like those, and I switched to that one, and that one broke. I don't know what the hell happened to that. I can't remember. Something happened to it where there was a big ass white spot on my screen, like I want to say the width of one of my fucking cans, the base of a can, in the middle of the screen. I don't know where it came from. No, I don't know why, but it was a white spot. So they had to replace it, and they asked me, you know, all we have is Samsung to replace it. I said, oh, that's fine, whatever. Because basically what they do is they give you a TV or whatever you have. They give it to you as a loaner until yours gets fixed. And I said, well, how much would it be? Just let me keep this one. They said, well, it'd be like $10 more. And then, of course, you know, I talked to them. They're like, don't worry about that. We're not going to raise your price for that. We're not going to do that. So, yeah. Yeah. Yep. Oh, my God. We were just talking about AMVs the other day. Literally yes. Just talking about that.
Yeah, you were talking about...
Me and Prinny were doing AMVs and shit together. AMVs. Oh, my gosh. I mean, he did it way more than I did. Way more. But he's the one that got me into doing it. And I was like, let me try. So I made one with a song from... what was it? The song's playing in my head, too. 3 Days of Grace. It was a song from 3 Days of Grace is what I did my first one with. I loved it. I thought it was awesome. And then he had a whole bunch. And I was like, dude, these look freaking slick. And he was showing me how to do it and everything. And yep, that's the one. Pain. My 3 Days of Grace. That was my first one. Because I was like, because for me, it was something new that I wanted to try. Got me into using computers more. And
right.
It took some work. It took some work. And I was like, this is a lot longer than I thought because he made it look easy. I was like, holy crap. Like, he's going through it, knows what he's doing. I have no idea what the hell I was doing. And I'm going through and he's like, oh, you got to do this. You got to, you know, change this, you know, adjust this. I was like, oh, okay. So he's showing me how to do this kind of stuff. And I loved it. I love doing it, but I haven't done it in a long time. I would love to do it again. I would.
Right.
But that's back when I had Photoshop and stuff and all those things on my computer that I don't have anymore. I don't have Photoshop anymore. I don't have any of that stuff. Sometimes I wish I did, though.
I'm not.
It's been forever.
I'm not good at any of that stuff.
When's the last time you've done one of those, Prinny? Has it been a while since you've done it in an AMV? Because you said what? It's been almost 10 years ago. I believe
the last time he's probably done an AMV
was an old computer.
Was back when I was still living with him.
Oh, wow. That's been a minute.
Well, you also got to think, YouTube's algorithms are like, oh, you're playing music that you don't own?
Right.
You're going to be copyrighted strike. Yeah. We're going to pull it down, yada, yada, yada.
Yeah, because I only made two or three. But Pain was the one that I remember the most because that was my first one that I did. I loved that one. Very long time. Last one was...
We planted after 3 years.
Wow.
Yes.
Nice, nice. Love you to death, yep.
I remember that because he was asking his brother what song would go good, what would go good with Planet After Story, and his brother is like, Camelot, love you to death.
Nice. It's been so long, dude.
He couldn't remember a song, and then he heard it, and he's like, that fits perfectly for what it is.
See, I did it the other way, because I would do the song, and I'm like, okay, I gotta find an anime that would work with the song, because I would go song, and then thinking of animes, and I'm like, I don't know what to pick.
Well, you gotta remember, Prenny was, at that time, he was your biggest anime buff.
Yes, yes,
you,
I agree.
You could, if you couldn't remember the name of the anime,
ask
him. You could start describing a scene that you remember from it, and he knew exactly what anime it was.
Exactly, exactly.
He was my go-to guy for if I wanted anime to know period. What anime was what yep. animes to watch and all this mm-hmm. and that.
Oh yeah, because I didn't know much about anime at the time because he's the one that got me into anime, but his brother would suggest otherwise. But he's the one that got me into a lot of certain animes that I didn't know about at the time. He introduced me to those. The Shadow of Intent. Oh, that'd be awesome. Oh, that'd be slick, dude. Have you thought about making more? Like, more AMVs?
Well...
Because that'd be pretty slick.
Well, it's kind of more difficult now to make AMVs.
Because of all the copyright stuff.
Yeah, because they really crack down on all those copyrights now.
Yeah. Because I never posted mine. I just kept it. I don't even remember where the hell I put it. Oh!
On that laptop?
No, it's on my old. It's my old silver PC.
Nice host, bro.
I get ideas all the time, dude. I feel you on that one. Ideas
that, and just don't. That do is it. That is pretty much 90% of people worldwide.
Yeah. Like
we get ideas in our head. Let's and we do just this. Never follow it through. Happen.
Like oh shit. It happens all the time. It does.
It really does. Oh no, Munchlax escaped.
Like, oh no, another one gone.
Yes, like he says, video game takes priority.
Yeah. Because I'm like, I don't know. I'm crazy, dude. But I think that when we do this the next time, because I know we go on tangents, we constantly do, we just did it earlier. Is have a topic to start with, and then we know it's going to go off to something else. It's going to happen either way.
We could have talked about, you know, the Expendables movies.
Damn.
We could have talked about Black Adam.
Right? Well, did you watch it yet?
Yeah, I watched it last night.
Did you like it?
I went home and watched it because you promised to watch it with me and then decided, nope.
Oh, all right. I'll send it to you. It's the same as everything else. It's the same as every other one.
The big brown one, 101.
Right. Exactly. But, oh, I heard that. That's hilarious. I could hear that. But, yeah, like, I watched all the Expendables again.
And we watched all the Expendable movies. That was what sparked the conversation between... Swayman in Sickness.
Yeah,
Discord.
Yeah.
Like, but he fell asleep. No, no, no. He didn't fall asleep. We were just watching
movies.
Watching the Expendables.
Unexpectables.
Yeah. Unexpectables. That's the D&D show I watch.
Right. Tried the regular password, didn't work. 88. Try that. Adding the other numbers. It looked like we were lagging there for a minute, but it could just be the TV. That's why I'm trying to look at that.
Hmm.
We're good. All right, I was checking because I'm like, oh shit, are we lagging again? But we watched those. We got to talk about we'll either do it next time or do it today. We can do it next time too. Is I kind of want to do a revamped one about the Mortal Kombat one we did, because I was watching. I've watched that thing like 4 fucking times now.
I've only watched it that time we were
put on the screen.
Yes.
I would want to do another revamped one about the Mortal Kombat, and what's coming up next is that. But then do one about Evil Dead as well.
I know I am.
That was directed to him. Sickness called you sexy. There you go. You're sexy for your shirt.
I know.
But I would want to do one on the Mortal Kombat one, but I also want to do
wanted to do one on Godzilla.
Yes, we should do that, actually. We should. He scared me in the dark. Black as night.
Yeah, you wanted to do one on Godzilla, but unfortunately...
You guys could pick topics, too. Like, we definitely do critiquing on movies. Like, definitely do that. If you... Every time. Like, never stops, dude. It had to be that one, too. Fucking Peter Griffin's laugh. But anyways.
I never actually cared for that, Cheryl.
I didn't either. But that was, like, perfect timing, though. But then just the laugh alone was funny. Oh, my God. But I want to do one on the Evil Dead films, the trilogy.
Yeah.
Those, and then I own the reboot-ish, whatever you want to call that. I
haven't watched that.
You haven't seen it?
No.
That's what he's going to do. He's staying here to watch that.
Ah.
You got to see it, I'm telling you. And then you're gonna do exactly what I did when I watched it, kind of like this.
He's gonna try and tie me down to the chair and make me watch the movie.
With some love sauce.
Gross.
But it has the horror touch to it, to where it's scary this time instead of it being goofy, you know, because I love Bruce Campbell to death.
The first one was amazing. The
first one was serious, yeah, it was.
The
it was
first
serious.
One was
yeah.
serious. The second one, which is kind of dumb. They try to pass it off that it's a sequel, but no, it's just a remake of the first. That's
pretty much.
It.
Like, the only thing they took away from it was the fact that he killed his daughter or killed his sister in the first movie, and then in this rebooted second one, it was his girlfriend was in it, and she got turned, and he killed her. Because in the series, I don't know if you've watched the series, where they talk about Cheryl, his sister.
Yes.
And they talk about his sister, so they still bring back things from the first movie, as in Cheryl. They do that.
Brittany's like,
My Name is Bruce was a fucking awesome movie, dude.
That
I love that movie.
To me, it was alright.
I like the fact that they were sitting there doing, kept saying, hey, you can save us, you can save us. She's like, I'm just an actor. I don't do anything. I'm just an actor. My name is Bruce. I'm just an actor.
Yeah,
that's it.
Well, then again, it's along the lines of those mythos where it's like actors who get so into their parts,
their roles,
that, that they think, that. Think they are that in real life.
Right.
Like one of the guys that was...
He played Joker, I think.
Oh, no. One of the guys that played Dracula.
Oh. That sounds really familiar.
I can't remember what his name was. I just know that he was so into his whole Dracula thing that he was even buried. When he died, he was buried in the Dracula suit.
Mark Hamill is the voice. Yes, Mark Hamill was the best voice actor for that.
Yes.
And Jet Nicholson was my favorite Joker of all time.
I'll be honest.
That's just me. Like, that's what we
I'll be honest. Heath Ledger's was not bad at all.
Right. It wasn't bad because I like he take the persona of how psychotic he could really be.
It's kind of like he was... The mixture between both Nicholson and Hamill's version for that.
Yeah, I could see that, yeah. Because, like I said, I grew up with Michael Keaton as Batman.
I mean, obviously, you know, Adam West as well. Yeah, I grew up with him too. But my favorite one out of those two became Michael Keaton's Batman was my favorite. Yeah, you know, that was my favorite Batman. Yes. Yep. Yep. Exactly. But Nicholson was my favorite Batman, or Nicholson was my favorite Joker, because that's just what I grew up with. And then later on, you know, they came out with, you know, Heath Ledger and all the other ones that played the, because like, what was after Heath Ledger? Was there another Joker after? Oh yeah, there was.
Jared Leto.
Yes. That's a whole nother one.
How can
that's
you forget Jared day. Leto? Easy, because he sucked at
sucked it. Ass. He did a horror. I don't care. I know y'all have the Suicide Squad fans out there.
But then again, there's also, you get glimpses of the Joker in that new The Batman movie.
I never watched it. Never did.
You get glimpses of him.
You do?
Yeah.
I've never seen it.
That's all I say.
Because I've never watched the new Batman movie. Because
I mean, I watched the new one. I actually liked how they decided to do the Riddler in that movie.
Who played the Riddler? Who was it? You know,
I can't remember his name. But all I know is in the Batman, how they did the Riddler was a lot better than how he's always ever been. Portrayed ever.
Even with Jim Carrey's?
Yes. Jim Carrey's was just, it's more cartoonish. Like it's Jim Carrey being the Riddler.
Yeah.
It was Jim Carrey acting like Jim Carrey. That's it.
I agree, Prinny. You know me, I'm a Marvel person. Well, I always am.
I don't know. I actually do like the DC animated movies.
Those are good. I will say that. I've been getting into a DC
kick when it animated comes to that. Movies are, in my opinion, better than the live action.
Oh yeah, ones. Yep. Because I've been getting into the Constantine ones, where those are the rated R movies. I'm like, they have rated R ones. I'm like, all right, well, I'm gonna check them out. And it was Constantine.
I mean, you what? Apocalypse War. Like I stated about Apocalypse War, you're literally seeing blood, guts,
all that stuff.
People are literally ripped in half and you're watching their intestines strewn across the screen and you're like,
they're trying to keep up. They're also trying to keep up with Mortal Kombat, because now they own Mortal Kombat. They own NetherRealm.
Well, of course DC anime is going to be better than Marvel. Look who owns Marvel.
Yeah, great. DC animated were way better than the Marvel man. Yep.
That's what it was.
The good 80s anime. Yes, anime back in the day was better than it is now.
Yeah,
unfortunately, it is the way it is.
But then again, I kind of agree with, you know, Prinny and his brother, where it's like a lot of the stuff prior to the 90s was really good.
Right, right. Oh, the detailed gore. Yeah.
Well,
what's up, JJ Money? What's going on? Blackout doesn't show up on this. There it goes. All right.
Yeah.
Not much. Doing the first episode of the show today.
The show.
Tangent's talk show's first episode today. But yeah, I agree with the whole detailed gore thing. I agree with that.
At least we didn't call it the big show, because you know we're big and it's the show,
right? You want to take a guess? I don't know who it is yet. Take a guess.
Yeah.
There it is, Mark Hamill, baby. Mark Hamill, all the way, baby. That's what's up.
Pass.
Exactly. Mark Hamill, all the way. That was my favorite Joker. Voiceover for Joker was Mark Hamill, was my favorite.
Yes.
I consider him the only voiceover for fucking
the Joker. The problem is, now anytime he's in anything later on, all I can see is Joker.
Right. It doesn't matter what it is. He's a Joker.
I mean, Netflix series, the Netflix He-Man, the Masters of the Universe series. Hamill plays a Skeletor in that.
I heard about that. Yeah, you're the one that told me that.
Yeah, and the worst part was they had the original voice actor.
It's insane. It's like, why do you do that?
It's like
the original said right there, hey, let's play him. Like, why not choose the original that actually voiced him before? Like,
you got the actual dude that started Skeletor.
Right.
Use him.
He's the one that did it.
Yes.
He is. That's the thing, though. Mark Hamill is an amazing voice actor, though. He is. And yes. He can do many different tones. He can do a lot of different things other than just the Joker.
Yeah, the only thing he was not good in was the latest three Star Wars movies.
Oh, yeah? What was
the new Star Wars movies?
Oh, the new one? I haven't watched any of them.
I did.
Nope. Never watched them. After, what was it? After, what was it? Damn it. It was the first newest one after the three. Star Wars
1. Force Awakens was the first of the three.
Was it?
Yeah, it's Force Awakens, Last Jedi, then Rise of Skywalker.
Oh, I'm trying to remember, because I'm like, I remember the three originals. I watched those.
Yes.
Then they came out with something. Episode one. Episode one.
You're talking about the prequel movies.
That's as far as I got. Was that? That's as far as I got. And nope. After I watched episode one, I'm like, I'm done. No more. I can't do it no more. Yes, I am. I am a hobo. Unlike Funimation, they use the same, like, four people. Yeah, exactly. Printy's right. They use the same four people for the whole damn thing. Exactly. Yes, exactly. Yeah, exactly.
Well, don't forget.
I didn't like
it. Don't forget, over there in Japan, they've used the same actor for Goku the whole time.
Yeah. Didn't the one for Goku pass in Japan? Was that the one that passed away?
I think it was the one for Frieza? Something like that.
Because I know you said something about one of them passing away.
Well, I know they had the American version, the English dubbed version of Frieza. He passed
away. That's the one. Okay, that's the one. Okay, all right. I was trying to remember which one it was.
You know, the one that That place is the teacher in Yu Yu Hakusho.
Really?
That was the one that did the Frieza.
No shit.
Could you not tell by the voice?
I didn't think about it.
That's it. I'm going to kick your ass. Then I'm going to reenact kicking your ass.
Yes.
But yeah. Like I said, I watched the first three originals and then watched episode one, and after episode one, I was done. I just couldn't do it.
Because I'm so used to the originals. I watched all three of those.
Yeah, I just couldn't do it.
But
it's just me, though. I mean, it's my opinion.
I mean, I really didn't like what they did with Anakin in 2 and 3.
Yeah.
With Hayden Christensen. Because literally, it makes it seem like he's a whiny teen.
That's what I heard. I did hear about that. That made him sound like he was like a whiny kid. I heard about that. And I was like, really? Because, like I said, I only saw that I can remember seeing episode one. There was an episode called episode two, right? There was a second one called episode two.
They weren't called episode one, two. It was episode one, Phantom Menace.
Okay.
Episode two, Attack of the Clones.
Oh, I did see that one. I think I saw that one.
And then three was.
I remember Revenge seeing Anakin as an adult. Yeah, I remember seeing I did see the second one. Yeah.
Now the only reason I ended up watching those movies is because I was great friends with my next door neighbor.
Yeah.
And he was a big Star Wars fan.
That's how you saw them?
Huh?
That's how you saw the other movies?
Yeah, that's how I saw them. Because he would get the movies. And because through him, I was reading all the Star Wars books.
Oh, okay. Okay.
And the thing that I hate was the fact that the new movies is like, we're gonna take this expanded lore that we made in all these books and chuck them out the window.
Wow. That's what I hate about when they do adaptations.
Yes, I agree. The expanded universe was amazing. Of course, I've read the latest timeline book in that. One of the latest ones. I just know that of Han and Leia's children, only one of them's still alive.
Really?
Yeah.
Damn. See, I haven't gotten that far into it. Like, I really haven't. Because I got, when, like I said, I got upset with the two newer movies at the time, and maybe not want to go any further. I was like, you know what?
It's just going to be as bad. The first one, the youngest child dies halfway through a war, an invasion war.
Wow. Spoiler alert.
And they also killed Chewbacca.
What?
Yes, they killed.
Oh my god!
They killed Chewbacca in it. Yes.
Right, I agree. 100% with Prinny on that.
If it's okay with Disney,
it's not okay with me. Nope.
Yeah, because I can't. Why do you think I no longer have Disney Plus? I don't. Care
I got mine for free, so it is what it is.
Yeah,
I don't use it though. I really don't watch Disney Plus.
I don't watch
Paramount Plus.
I stopped.
Will Chewie dies anyways
for paying his life debt to Han.
Yep. But
that sucks. Except in the new movie, he's still alive.
Excuse me. Huh. Damn.
But yeah, they killed off Chewbacca. They killed off Chewbacca. They kill off the youngest solo child. They kill Luke's wife.
Oh, he said do not. Okay.
Huh?
This right here. He said, do not. I was trying to read what Brittany was saying. But I didn't know that, dude. Because I love Chewbacca, dude. And now that I know he's dead, I was like, man, I'm mind blown right now. Like, really? That
just happened? And then they decided to have one of the twins, because they had twins.
Yeah.
One of the twins took a trip down the dark side.
Wow.
Yeah, so the other one had to take that one out.
Damn, dude, that's crazy.
So brother and sister fought each other, and one of them won.
That's just crazy. I never knew that.
The funny part was that they slightly started to have it where the sister was going to go down the path of the dark side after her brother's death.
Yeah.
But then all of a sudden it's like, no, I'm good.
Hmm. Okay.
Yeah, well, they made the son's name Ben in the new movie.
Oh, okay.
But that shouldn't have been Han and Leia's child, because they had no association with Ben.
Okay. So how many movies have there been total besides the three originals and then going
there's nine movies in the, as they're now calling it, the Skywalker saga.
Really?
Yeah, they're calling these nine movies the Skywalker saga.
Damn. Nine movies?
Yeah, there's nine movies. Then you got that stupid Clone Wars movie that started off the Clone Wars series.
Dude. Because all I thought there was like five movies total, and I did not know there was nine.
I did not know that. Yeah, I never watched Rogue One.
I heard about that one, I didn't see it. Isn't that the one with Donnie Yen in it?
Yes.
That's the one, that's the one I was kind of tempted to check
Rogue
out.
Rogue One. Then there was Solo, which tanked so hard it almost ruined any possibilities of anything more to do with Star Wars.
And that's the one that was directly about Han Solo, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I did want to check out Rogue One because I saw Donnie Yen. I'm like, Donnie Yen's fucking badass. Because
after this Solo movie, they were going to make a...
Okay.
They were going to make a Kenobi movie.
Okay. Yeah, because after he just said, I was like, okay. Yeah, because I used to have the original trilogy on VHS. I had the box set. I don't have it anymore.
I mean, who would not want to have the original
trilogy? I miss it, dude. I don't know what happened to it. I don't remember. I had the original box set of the trilogy.
And no idea where it went. The part that's annoying, I was discovering that strictly pretty much way back in the day...
For the Empire. Oh, my back. Oh, there we go. My back needed to pop.
Lies, you needed to fart.
That will come eventually. Almost guarantee it. But yeah. Like I said, didn't even know. I did not know there was fucking 9 movies. That's insane. That's crazy. But then again, like, look at how many movies have sequels these days.
Yeah.
Like, you could throw in the Halloween movies. Like, there's a gazillion of those. There's a bunch of Friday the 13th movies. There's a bunch of
Don't forget, there's technically one movie, one Star Wars movie that was so bad that they won't air it or play the whole part of it.
What?
Yeah, the Star Wars Christmas special.
I don't think I even heard of that one.
Exactly.
It's that bad.
Yeah.
It's so bad we're not gonna air it at all. It's that bad.
Yeah.
And the worst part is
that's when Boba Fett made his first appearance.
What?
Yep.
Wow.
He made his first appearance in that Star Wars special.
Because I know they have The Mandalorian out now on Disney Plus. I know they have that. I've never watched it at all. Everybody's like, "Oh, it's amazing! You gotta watch it."
I never.
They need to make Shadow of the Empire movies.
Yes.
That would be awesome.
Now,
CG, the original cast. Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, Shadows of the Empire, you know, that takes place between five and six.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, between Empire and Return of the Jedi?
Yeah. Yep. All right, now you're talking about, yeah. All right, yep. Okay. Empire and Jedi. Yep. 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 I had to think there for a second. I'm like, now I remember. Because like I said, I used to have the trilogy, man, but I don't know what happened to it. I'm pissed. I'm like, I don't know what happened to my trilogy, dude. I used to have it on VHS, the box set. And I was like, I don't know what happened to it. I don't remember.
Apparently, there's in the old original, the ones way back in the day.
Yeah.
There's apparently a scene in one of the Star Wars movies that never transferred to any of the newer ones.
Really?
Yes.
Damn. I'd be okay with the remake of that game, too. Yep. I could see it. I could see.
The Shadows of the Empire?
Yeah.
I never played that one.
But it'd be good to have a remake of some of this stuff.
Well,
I could see it.
There are some,
or shame.
It's just half the time you're like, what?
Yeah.
What all do you... Who, if they're going to remake them, who are they going to recast to play them? Because...
You wouldn't know who to cast for it. Because it's like, it's been so long that you don't know who to cast for it anymore. You wouldn't be sure.
Yeah.
It's been so long. But yeah. It would be nice to have that, but like you said, who's gonna cast it?
Who are they gonna get to direct it? Because
it's so long.
Well, look what happened with the new movies. People thought Force Awakens was good. The Jedi Fallen Order.
He was in there too?
Huh?
What?
I don't know. He's I think he's talking about the game, not.
Oh, I was about to say what? I was about to say, damn, he was in it too.
Yeah. I never played that Fallen Order. See,
now I've like this is the thing. Prinny knows about this. Is like,
well, he didn't like it.
Oh, he didn't.
No, he hates.
No, okay, all right.
Yeah, he hates it with a passion.
Wow. Like I'll go into this one right here. Like, there's games that I don't like, that I can't see myself playing, but I love watching people play. Prinny's got games that he's played before that I won't play. But I'd be hanging out with him, and he'll play him, and I'd be like, getting all into it, like, this is awesome, like, whoa, like, this game is awesome. But like, if I try to play it, I don't think I would be able to get into it. But watching him play, I was like, this is freaking awesome, like that. There's times that, like, for instance, we'll go with the one game that everybody's like getting into now. What is it? Elden Rings. That one, the new one, Elden Ring, whatever.
They're not getting into it now. They were
into it, like that kind of thing. Like, I can't play that for myself. It's not a game that I would play.
Well,
but I would watch them
play
that.
But then again, we're not
into those kind of games.
We're not into those.
Yeah, but I'll watch them play, especially like I said, I'll watch them play it, but I won't play it. The story is said to be inspired by the original trilogy, but it was actually a ripoff of it. Oh, wow. Just change the characters involved. Wow.
Of course.
Yeah. That's nothing new. They do that shit all the time now.
Yeah.
They ruin all the original. They ruin shit because of it. That's what they do.
They do a lot. They'll do a lot of reboot movies, and then they'll like try. They'll reboot it, and then they're like, "Oh no."
He's getting his channel points. Hold on a second. Channel points.
Yes.
Sickness is still here with us. What's up, brother?
Well, the sickness was checking the uptime.
Damn. I didn't even know he was still here. I didn't know.
Well, he was so engrossed in our conversation.
Buggy Cell 2, both consistently.
Yeah.
Really? Damn.
Wasn't that the same way with that Marvel Adventures game?
Oh, Omega? Marvel
no.
Omega?
No, that... The recent of Marvel Avengers
game. Oh, PS4? Well, PS4, Xbox, whatnot, all them. Because I have that game, Marvel Avengers, I have that.
Yeah, it was, last I knew, it was buggy as heck.
Yeah, because I have the game, I played it, and I got into it, started playing it. Then again, I also got it, like, months after it was out. I got it way later on. Way later on. I didn't have any issues with it. I really didn't. But also didn't get that far into it as well. Smoked some flour over the last time of 3 weeks. It's been that long. See, now you got to get your zooted. You got to check see how zooted you are now. I uploaded 2 videos of it. I had a rat explode me
out of bounds, and there was a big hole that didn't load.
Wow. It was a rat? That's insane. Nope, not there. Oh, what's up, Arctic? Shit, Arctic's in now. Damn.
You know what that means is about to come up.
Every time. I already know.
I'm a hallucination.
My boy. Everybody. But yeah. Like I said, like, he was talking about things being buggy and stuff like that. I have, like I said, I got it way later on though, and got it because it was on sale when I got it. It was like 3 or 4 months later. It was on sale when I got it.
I remember one game that I'm like, did not care for, or what was it? That I was talking about, this, pretty much the sequel to Ghost Recon Wildlands. Breakpoint.
Yeah.
I was always commenting, man, that game must have sucked.
Oh, he has to go to the bathroom again. All right, give us a couple more minutes and we'll get it done. Give us a couple more minutes.
That game must have sucked so bad because that game was always on.
Okay.
Was always on sale.
Yeah, it instantly went from being full price, and a week later it go down to like 60% less, and then two weeks later go back up and go back down.
I'm currently trying to play Wildlands again, and I'm actually working on trying to.
I still have that on the PlayStation too. I want to get back into that actually. Yeah. I want to get back to the Wildlands.
I got it from that PlayStation Extra, the Plus Extra.
Okay, I don't know how I got mine. I have no idea, but I have it. I never remember buying it.
It was free.
I got it before that, though. Before it was free, I don't know how I got it. I don't remember.
I bet if Prinny went through again, he'd probably kick some butt.
What game does he not play and doesn't kick butt? Like seriously, like, like name a game that I've ever seen him have like a really hard time with.
Call of Duty.
He destroys us every time. Like
you know him versus campers.
Yeah, true. Yes, campers suck.
Yes, campers suck. those campers are gonna piss him off, and you know that.
But yeah, like I said, name a game that he's played and he's bad at. I every time I've seen him in person play a game, like, there's times when I'll see him in person playing a game, and he just kicks ass. And I'm like...
Now, there was one game I started to play that I just stopped playing, which...
That's it. I'm gonna kick your ass. Then I'm gonna reenact kicking your ass.
This flower isn't even green. It's full on... Holy shit! Full on purple. Always get slaughtered by people. Going all in with 7-2. Damn, dude. Shit. Yeah. That's crazy. But unfortunately, guys, I'm going to have to call it because I didn't realize what time it was. And it's Sunday. It's not Saturday. I kept thinking Saturday for some reason.
Yes.
But yeah, we're going to call it here. My dog's got to go. My dog's dinner time. We got to get dinner started and everything else. But if you guys have topics, go ahead, do me a favor, Slothy, or anybody, drop in the Discord, type in the link for the Discord for me real quick. That way I can stay up to date with everything. I have the one chip challenge is coming up, and 24-hour stream on top of that is coming up next Saturday.
I just don't think that was ever a bright idea to do the one chip challenge
and the 24-hour stream.
Yes.
Thank you, Slothy, for driving the Discord.
Especially when you know that Chip is probably gonna break you.
Oh man. Like I said, seeing how someone do it, dude, killer. That's be killer. But I do want to say thank you for everybody that came in. If you guys have any suggestions on things to talk about, let me know in the comments. Let me know. Or just in Discord, shoot some stuff out in general chat or DM me on Discord, doesn't matter either way.
Yep.
I'm probably gonna make a spot for suggestions for the show when we do it. We're going to try and do it every other weekend. We're going to try and do it on Saturdays every other weekend. About the same time like that. Play games. Exactly. Play some games. Exactly. My intention is to do that tonight too. But like I said, I got to go ahead and call it here because time to make dinner and all that good stuff. And,
my dog has to go to the bathroom. He has cranky people.
So thank you guys everybody for coming today. I had a blast. I had fun. I don't know if you did, but I did. I had fun. I did.
I had
Toadie. What is up, dude? Holy shit.
And then Toadie shows up.
Oh my god. Of course. It's gotta happen. You know it. You know it. I appreciate you. What's up, Toadie? We are just finishing up.
I want to eat something. I haven't.
He's going to eat, and then he's going to play
I haven't eaten since I went to sleep last night.
He meant to eat before he came here. What's up, Toadie? This is our talk show, man.
I was actually planning on bringing some food with.
Right?
I mean, but yeah. He has some chips here that he could have been snacking on.
But yeah, guys,
stay
up to date with everything. Get in Discord, check everything out, and we will let you know when everything's going on. So yeah, appreciate
Slothy.
Right. But thank you all for coming in. We're calling it a night here. We appreciate all you guys for coming in. Seriously, I had a blast doing this. I do. We're going to be doing this, trying to do this every other Saturday. We're going to try to keep it steady. We're going to try. So if things get better and higher in there, we might do it more often. We'll see what happens. We're just gonna see what happens. But I'm gonna hop off, eat. Oh, yep, same thing. Remember, it'll be technically this Saturday, whatever you want to call it. We'll be doing the 24-hour stream and shit like that. All right, man, sounds good. So, but yeah, I had a blast. I had fun. I had fun.
So, I had a vape.
I had a vape. But thank you guys again for coming out and stay, like I said, keep up with Discord.
All right.
And you'll know when stuff goes down. So we'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much. Catch you later. Have a good night, good morning, whatnot. Have a great day. See you guys later.
We're in the lead. They're driving us back.
You fell into the hole you dug yourself. It's not you.
Dropped one.
What's a queen? I'm third grenade queen. Woo.